Live from the beautiful sun-kissed island of Kauai, it's Animal Talking. Tonight, join Gary and his guests, T-Pain, GameSpot's Chastity Vicencio, and musical guest, Very Handsome Billy. And now, because this island really is the perfect tax shelter, here's your host, Gary Whitta.
I gotta host yours, man.
Ladies and gentlemen, performing live, T-Pain.
Boop, boop!
Yeah!
Boop, boop!
Oh, yeah. Hey, you think it's a game? I get my coins. A bitch, I ain't playing. I'm with my boys. They go insane. They got them toys. And they go wait. Set up. But they go bang. Yeah, yeah. Bitch, they go bang. Bang, wait. Toss it,
throw it up,
motion. Hey, bitch, take a bang. Yo, yeah. I got two watches.
Bitch, I got time.
Yeah, bitch, I'm watching.
You gon' be mad.
You better watch it. Oh, yeah, bang, bang.
Hey,
haters can't stop me.
Oh, no, they can't.
Right in my pocket.
Big man, big man.
Yeah. Your girl beside me. Oh, yeah, bang, bang.
Bang, bang.
I got the keys.
Open it up.
Open your please. I go overseas. Oh, no, bang, bang.
Pick up the flight.
I hop out the Porsche.
Exotic.
I open the doors.
I got it.
Yeah, that's a horse. Oh. Conversations with my swag. Diamonds on my neck look like a wall of platinum plaques. Yeah, I've been that nigga, yeah, that's facts on facts.
Hey,
you think it's a game? I get my coins. A bitch, I ain't playing. I'm with my boys. They go insane. They got them toys. And they go wait. Set up. But they go bang. Yeah, yeah. Bitch, they go bang. Bang, wait. Throw it. Toss it.
Throw it up.
Hey, bitch,
yeah.
You got the champ on it.
You got the champ.
So you got the stamp on it.
I put the stamp.
Wrap it up, put a clamp on it. Oh, no. Bang, bang.
Bang.
Turn it like an amp on it.
Turn it up. Turn it up.
I come and dance on it.
Turn it up. Turn it up.
You catch a cramp on it. Oh, no. Bang, bang.
Bang.
Get on my pitch.
Open the book.
I'm getting paid.
Well, take a look.
Cause I made the wave. Oh, no. Bang, bang.
Bang.
I got some advice.
Listen up.
Pick up the price.
Pick it up.
Don't let them think twice. Oh, trading on your swag. Take that shit from me, boy. I've been there and I've been back. Now I'm still that nigga. Yeah, that's facts on facts.
Hey,
you think it's a game? I get my coins. A bitch, I ain't playing. I'm with my boys. They go insane. They got them toys. And they go wait. Set up. Bitch, they go bang. Yeah, yeah. Bitch, they go bang. Bang, wait. Throw it.
Throw it up.
Oh, shit. Hey, bitch, take a...
T-Pain, everybody. My goodness.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you,
what
thank you.
What an absolute singer of a track to open the show. Like, T-Pain.
Thank you.
Absolutely killing it at the top of the show here. Come and take a seat on the couch here. We got to go on the couch.
What's happening?
In honor of your appearance, I've changed the KK Jazz that we usually play, and I'm playing KK Cruisin', which is KK Slider's hip hop album.
I really appreciate that.
Wanted to make you feel at home.
I really appreciate it. I really appreciate it. This is fitting.
We do what we can to help our guests feel at home here on Animal Talking.
You did,
man. Now, Payne, I gotta say, when we did the sound check yesterday. And you did the rehearsal of that performance. You were so tickled by what was happening that, like, I could hear you cracking up over the mic. Like, we actually had to mute you for the live performance because I couldn't trust you to not, like, crack up through the whole performance.
Because it's so perfect, man. What you're doing here is so monumental, and it's such a thing that's bringing people together through a common interest, and everything that you're doing, man, this is just so great. And the way that it comes together, it wasn't like a funny laugh, or it wasn't like a what the hell is this laugh. It was more like a Oh my God, this is so great.
Like, no, I felt like you had this like childlike glee. Like you were just so delighted to be messing around here on the set. Based on yesterday's sound check with Payne, and based on the 10 minutes that we spent in the green room prior to coming on, I can pretty confidently say, and we've had some good ones, but I can pretty confidently say tonight is going to be an absolute train wreck. There's no other scenario.
For sure. If anybody's ever seen one of my Twitch streams, we already know where this is going.
Oh my God. Adam Nickerson, how are you doing? We've always forgotten. How are you, sir?
I'm doing pretty great. Mr. Payne here has been entertaining me for a while.
Oh, my God. He's just been cracking everyone up in the green room. Who knew? He was a talented musician, but who knew he was this funny?
No, I'm not funny. This is reality and tragedy meeting in one place and becoming a joke all by itself.
Adam, you know, we always do this on the ever since our new wardrobe supervisor, Kate, started dressing you. I always like to see what you come out here and show us what you're wearing.
Look at this.
This is nice.
What do you think of Adam's outfit?
It's like a Run DMC / mariachi type thing
It feels like an Elvis kind of Evel Knievel kind of vibe or something going on.
It's an Elvis Evel Knievel / boxing promoter.
Yeah. It's a weird mashup.
It's a lot going on there. It's a lot of fashion. A lot of studs.
As the band leader, Adam has a lot more freedom to express himself in terms of fashion. I have to wear a suit, but he can do whatever he wants. And apparently he does. It's
super duper American. So that's pretty cool.
You know what, Payne? I want to get us off on the right foot here. You know, I gave you a little gift before the show in a gold bag. I'm going to ask you to jump off the couch and open that gift right now.
I will jump off the couch right now. Watch this. All right. Okay. The thing is, you gave me a present yesterday too, and they're both
open the one that's in the gold wrapper.
Do you see it?
Do you see it?
Yeah.
Do you have it? Obviously.
Now I want for the people.
Oh, home, let's go! Oh, are you ready?
Are you gonna put it on? You gotta put it on.
Are you ready?
Yeah, go for it. Oh, look at that. Oh my God. The king.
Oh yeah.
The it's king over. Of hip hop is here on Animal Talking. I don't know if you're aware, but that crown cost 1 million bells.
You know what? That makes sense. That makes sense.
Because... it is the most baller item in the game. And Animal Talking has gifted it to you as our guest.
I really appreciate it. You guys are billionaires, and I really appreciate that, man.
Multi-billionaires. In fact, special thanks to our stylist, Kate. She actually got you that gift. So you should give Kate a shout out.
Shout out to Kate. One love, Kate. I love you.
I love it.
This is awesome.
I'm gonna crank up the KK cruising a little bit because I'm kind of feeling the vibe here with the.
It's a good vibe.
It's making me feel very chill. T-Pain, thank you so much for joining us on the show. What a treat it is to have you here.
It's really cool to be here, man. I got to tell you.
Oh my goodness.
Don't worry about that. Man, it's really cool to be here, man. I mean, the thing you've done here is create something that can not only hold everybody over until we get out of this weirdness that we're going through right now, but it's such a delight to see that you actually did it right.
I'm so glad that came through. For those of us who are more than 10,000 people in the chat right now, we're off the hook here with the audience. So for anyone who may be discovering us first time, this is Animal Talking. It is the world's premier late night talk show that takes place entirely within the world of Animal Crossing. And this started a couple of weeks ago as me and my friends goofing around in the basement of my virtual house here on the beautiful sunkissed island of Kauai, playing dress up, and it kind of caught on. It kind of went viral. Next thing you know, I've got celebrity publicists beating down my door. I'm booked out for the end of the month. I've got record labels calling me up trying to get their clients on the show. It's completely gotten out.
And just as a side note, nobody knew there was a right way to do this.
No, and I still don't know the right way to do it.
Oh no, this is it. This is the one. This is it. You literally did it. This is This is it.
I gotta say, we are, you know, as dumb as it is, this whole thing's put together with shoestring and duct tape. There's no budget, no staff, but we are a real, people come on and they say, hey, this is just like a real late night talk show.
Hey, man, shoestring and duct tape worked well for MacGyver. I think it'll work well
for
anybody.
We MacGyvered a whole talk show out of nothing.
And when
people say to me, hey, it's just like a real talk show, I say, no, it's a real talk show. We do everything that Jimmy Fallon and Conan and the big boys do. In fact, right now, we're doing things they can't do. Jimmy Fallon doesn't have guests on a couch. I do.
It's true. Conan,
we're in the metaverse. We have transcended beyond the physical space into the metaverse. And we can do things that no one else can do.
I don't think anybody's giving crowns. I've only received a crown one time in my life.
And I picked you up at the airport. Do you think Jimmy Kimmel's going to pick you up?
You picked me up at the airport? Nobody's going to pick you up at the airport. What is wrong with you?
These guys aren't picking you up at the airport. We provide a level of service to our guests that no one else
did. We didn't practice social distancing. We didn't do any of that.
We don't have to because we're in the metaverse. Social distancing doesn't matter.
We hugged when I got to the airport. It was crazy.
We can hang out. We can do whatever we want. So this is a real late night talk show. We have celebrity guests. We have live music. We have stand up comedy. We do everything the big boys do. In fact,
I'm just gonna.
Where's he gone? Where's he going? What's he doing?
I don't know.
Is he just running around?
I just can't sit still for.
I mean, look, mi casa es tu casa. Feel free.
I got restless leg syndrome, and I couldn't.
If you feel the need to run up and like get your wiggles out, by all means. Go ahead and do that. I have a 7-year-old. She's much the same. And the funny thing is, Payne, here's the thing. All of the so-called big boys, they're all stuck in their basements as well. They can't put on their shows right now. Stephen, nobody can do a show out of a broom closet.
Nobody can do anything you're doing right now.
I'm the only player in the game right now.
I would say this, though. I'm the only one in here with a mask on, so...
I like the fact that you have taken those precautions even into the virtual space.
I do what I can.
You've heard of computer viruses. Who knows?
You never know, man. You never know.
Payne, I want to ask you about that song that you opened the show with. It's called Think It's a Game. And I thought it was a wonderful choice to open the show because it seems like it's a love letter to video games, right?
It is a love letter to video games. I actually made that for my Twitch channel. And it rings off, man. Every time I start my Twitch channel and I play the intro with Think It's a Game playing in the background, it actually gets people hyped to see me be trash at video games. So,
I'm telling you, every time I hear that little Mario coin sound effect, I'm all in. Like, I'm ready to play. I love that.
You gotta have that sometimes, man. It's an homage, if you will, an homage.
Homage. And that's what I like about it. It feels like it comes from a true place. You're not trying to jump on some kind of video game bandwagon because they're cool. Like, I feel like we talked about it a little bit when we did our pre-interview. But tell me about T-Pain and video games. Are you old school? Are you OG? Have you been playing video games all your life?
I'm OG, man. I'm OG. I think my first video game that I played, like, by myself without my brothers in there interrupting me and unplugging the second controller, I think the first one I played... First player on was The Lion King.
Genesis or Super Nintendo?
I think it was it Super Nintendo or was it Sega? It was obviously a long time.
It was on both, but I think most people played the Genesis version.
I don't think I got to play on the Genesis. No, I actually only got to play it on the Genesis. I only got to play on the Genesis version and nothing before that because my brothers were dicks. So
were you guys like fighting over the controller, like for who gets to play next?
Oh no, I'm the youngest in the family, so there's no fighting. It was just like you can't play it.
You just have to wait your turn. Oh, that's
right. Absolutely. And the only way I can wait my turn is for them to like go to work or something. So
but that was kind of when you came of age, like in that 16-bit era, Sega Genesis, Super Nintendo.
I came around 16-bit, so I was doing Lion King, which is the Dark Souls of the Genesis era, and then Battletoads, Toe Jam and Earl came along. And then,
you are quoting some brutally like Battletoads is a legendarily difficult game. Do you ever finish that game?
No. Who did anybody?
No, it's a tough game. It's a tough game to beat.
No, I didn't finish any of that stuff, man. Toe Jam and Earl was one of my favorites. Man, I had a lot. I had a lot back then. Once I discovered GoldenEye, I think that changed my life.
Oh, on the N64, another classic.
Yeah, yeah. So what happened was I had a neighbor that lived across the street from me, and they were relatively rich, you know, as opposed to everybody else in the neighborhood who were ridiculously poor. So yeah. They had every game, every anime, every Gundam model. Like, you know what I'm saying? And I used to go over there every day and see what new game they always had. And,
right.
You know, I think that's what really started my whole thing. But we were the first ones in the neighborhood to have the PS1. And oh, I think that kind of made me a little popular. So suck a butt, everybody else.
What are your all-time favorite video games?
My all-time favorite? Ooh-wee. Any Just Cause.
Oh, good call.
Yeah, any Just Cause is dope. Man, all time, that's going to be...
Well, let me ask you this. Go ahead.
The Last of Us?
Yeah, so you excited for the sequel? It's coming out next month.
Oh, I'm so excited. I'm excited for the new one. Even though there's been a thousand spoilers and
people complaining about it. Yeah.
And people complaining about it so much, I don't think that's going to hinder me any from playing that game. But, yeah, The Last of Us, I think... What I just finished the other night, babe? Oh, The Last Jedi. Just finished The Last Jedi the other night. That was
Jedi Fallen Order?
Yeah. Fallen Order.
How'd you like that one?
I actually liked it a lot.
Yeah?
A bunch, man. It was actually difficult in places where it was supposed to be difficult in. And, you know, the game was beautiful. The landscape was amazing. The design is just... out of this world.
Did you play that goose game where you go around hassling people as a goose?
I have the goose game on Epic, and I have the goose game on Switch. I play goose game on both. I'm literally not being able to get past the garden.
This is why I'm excited to have you on the show, Payne, because let me tell you something, first of all. You would be amazed, and I'm sure you know this, right? Because there was a point when, like, you blew up, right? And you became a big star. Like, you weren't a big star, and then one day you were a big star. And what's happening with me, and I'm not saying I'm a big star or anything, but I've noticed something in the last couple of weeks. Let me tell you, Payne, I've had so many people crawling out of the woodwork. Oh, hey, Gary, what's happening? I hear you've got a hit talk show. Oh, yeah. Funny, I'm hearing from you right now. What a surprise. Right.
Oh, my God.
But, and you know, I've got big stars that want to come on the show, not because they play Animal Crossing, not because they love video games, but because they know that this is in the zeitgeist, this is the hot thing right now, and they want to glom onto that. But my preference is to have people like you on, not just because you're like a legit celebrity and a cool person, but because you're totally authentic. Like, you play Animal Crossing, you play video games.
Man, I had a long conversation with my team about 2 days ago, and I was like, you know, we have meetings periodically about what press I want to do and what interviews and stuff like that. And I'm like, man, can we do something that I actually like? Like, can we actually go to something, like, you know, because it's always with me, especially, you know, the normal, like the other interviews that I do, the Breakfast Club and, you know, Complex and things like that. And, you know, the normal things that rappers and singers do in my genre. And I'm like, man, I don't want to do any of those. But if you bring me something that got something to do with games or something that I actually do every day, something that got like with games and cars or something that I actually like doing. Oh, my God. And then they brought me your thing. And I'm like, guys, I don't want anything for this. I'm not here to promote anything. I actually want to do this. I can do this for hours on end.
That's what I like. You're not here because you've got something to promote. You're here because you just want to hang out and have a good time.
Because I already do this.
Right?
Like, this is another, like, when I came to your island this time, I got another, I got 1,000 Nook miles for this.
Oh, yeah. and $1 million crown, don't forget.
And $1 million crown. Like,
a million bell crown.
This is amazing.
No one walks away from this show empty-handed.
Yeah, I'm not here for anything other than just talking and just chilling. Like, trust me, this is very enjoyable. My whole family is in tune to this right now. My wife is sitting across the room. My daughter's upstairs watching this right now. Like, my daughter and I have become not great, but better friends than we were.
Because
we're already friends. We already have a lot of the same interests. And I started playing Jesus Christ, wow. I started playing Animal Crossing because she started playing it first. And I wanted to see what she was so happy about. And it brought me closer to my daughter. And now my daughter, my wife, my sons, my brother-in-law upstairs, he's like, everybody in this house is playing Animal Crossing, and we're all a better family because of it. And
you know what? That rings so true to me, because we had the same thing here at home. Like, everyone's stuck at home with the coronavirus. We were starting to kind of get on each other's nerves a little bit. Me, my wife, and my daughter. We love each other, but you know what it's like. It can get to be too much. Animal Crossing came into the house. We got 3 copies of it. One for each of us, and the mood in the house just lifted instantly. Like, to watch the face on the smiles on my wife's face and my daughter's face when they started setting up their islands, it was like, boy, did this game come out at the right time, just when we needed it.
I mean, what a great release strategy this
was. Oh my god! Well, you know, it was delayed. It was supposed to come out earlier, but the delay actually ended up being the perfect timing for it.
Oh man,
sometimes things happen for a reason.
Absolutely.
Now, Payne, you've been keeping it real ever since you came on the show, and you've inspired me to keep it real. I was going to read it because something just popped into my whispers, and I want to address this. I have said many, many times, and I'm going to say it again right now in front of an audience of like 13, 14,000 people, however many it is right now. It's a lot of people.
I know.
I have had so many people, corporate sponsors, legit corporate sponsors, big, big brand names, approaching me, wanting to slap their logo on the show, wanting to commercialize this, monetize it, turn it into a commodity. I've told them all, I don't want your money. Go away. I'm not interested.
Absolutely.
I already have a job. I make money at my actual job.
This is a hobby.
Don't get me wrong, because I like Kellogg's Corn Flakes. Nothing against them. But as soon as this becomes, hey, here's Animal Talking brought to you by Kellogg's Corn Flakes, it's over.
Nah, bro.
It's
fuck
over. It's over.
Fuck.
So, and I've literally got, I'm not gonna name any names. I've got literally someone in my whispers right now offering me big cash money to slap their logo on my stream. I don't want their money.
Gary, how much money?
I'm not gonna say any, I'll tell you after the stream.
I would also like to know that.
Yeah, well, you want me to send them your way, Payne? You can slap it on, maybe put it on your stream. I don't want it.
I might. I like money a lot. But still. Right,
we'll talk afterwards.
No, this is, I mean, no, bro, this is super duper organic, man. And I really feel like you got something going that can't be interrupted by ads can't be toppled by big corporations. And you know what? The only way I feel like people could even come into this realm is if they actually like what's happening and not so much as the opportunity. It's not about your show is growing and I see the numbers. It's about, yo, we play Animal Crossing too.
T-Pain, you're speaking my language so hardcore right now. I'm loving everything you're saying.
I'll tell you what, if Nintendo hits you and you say no, we got a problem. Me and you got a problem.
I've said before, and also, again, there might be someone listening. I've said before, I will reject all corporate sponsorship. I will not endorse any product on this show except chicken and a biscuit. I love those goddamn savory snack crackers. If the good people at Nabisco want to get in touch.
Wait. What is that?
You never had chicken and a biscuit? Oh my god.
I've had chicken and I've had biscuits.
You've had like a Ritz cracker, right?
Wait. What kind of biscuit are you talking about?
Okay, it's like a Ritz cracker, like a cracker that you would put cheese on, but it tastes like chicken.
Oh, that what?
You gotta try it. Go to the store tomorrow. Get yourself some chicken and a biscuit. I'm promising
you. Nobody carries that here.
You can thank me later.
Nobody carries that here. I guarantee it. Wait, where are you from?
I'm in San Francisco. You're in LA, right?
No. Cause, not LA. I know it's not in LA. I'm in Atlanta.
You're gonna get chicken and a biscuit in Atlanta. I'm telling you.
Nobody sells that.
The Safeway. What do you have there? Vons? Safeway? What do you have?
None of that. What are these names you're saying?
You don't have supermarkets? What's your local grocery? What's your market? Where do you go?
None of those things. What is that?
You know what, Payne? I'm going to talk to you after the show. I'm going to send you some goddamn chicken and a biscuit. I'm going to get some chicken and a biscuit in your hand, no matter what it takes.
I don't think these places exist that you keep talking about.
I'm going to hook you up.
I've been complaining and asking them for chicken and a biscuit for weeks. I've been looking online, trying to track it down. Meanwhile, T-Pain says...
Yeah, exactly.
I got another streamer buddy. His name's JP. He texted me. He said, what is the deal with chicken and a biscuit? Because I've been banging on about it for a while. He said, what is the deal with chicken and a biscuit? I said, go get some. He went and got some. The next day, he texted me and said, thank you. Thank you for bringing these into my life.
The first problem is, me and you are talking about two different biscuits.
Yeah.
This is not a British like cookie biscuit thing. The product is, it's an American product. It's called chicken and a biscuit.
You said it's like a Ritz cracker.
Don't take it up with the people at Nabisco. They call it chicken and a biscuit, but it's like a Ritz cracker.
It's not
a
biscuit.
It's a salty, savory snack cracker.
I think they made that to appeal to British.
If I have to put some in a box and send FedEx them to you, I'm gonna do it.
Do it.
It's the only way to explain it to you.
Absolutely, because we don't have that here.
You don't have that in Atlanta. I find that so hard to believe. If you were up in Canada or something, I would get it because that country's just weird. But like down here.
Oh my God!
You
gotta
get all this stuff.
My wife knows what it is. What the fuck?
She knows what it is. There you go.
My wife is a foodie though. Like that. Like those are people that like search for like different foods.
I'm gonna get some chicken and a biscuit into T-Pain's hands before this.
Send me that shit.
I am sending it to you. And I want you to come back on the show after you've had the chicken and a biscuit, and I want you to tell me about how much it's changed your life.
I wish there was a way for me to just like show up on your island.
You got a Walmart there. You got a Target, right? They sell them there. You got to have these things.
They don't though. They don't though. I've never seen it.
I swear. You know what? I'm going to bring the chicken and a biscuit segment to an end because I feel like I'm not getting through to T-Pain here as much as I
want. You're not going to, because I don't believe it. Because there's entire restaurants dedicated to chicken. Also, as well as biscuits.
What is going on?
There's entire restaurants. You tell me that you can just pick it up off the shelf from the floor?
Entire
conglomerates are going to fall because you just let everybody know that they don't have to go to those restaurants anymore. And now you can just pick up that whole thing off the shelf right now.
Yep. Gary's in Big Biscuit's pocket.
You remember, Adam, remember what I said earlier about this being a train wreck?
down to Big Biscuit.
Oh my God. Oh my God. So, but anyway, I just want to get
back.
I just want to reiterate my point.
If the good
people at Nabisco are listening, call me. Win a website at gmail.com. That's my public facing email. Have my people talk to your people. We'll figure something out. I have another show as well, Animal Crossing Mornings.
Somebody just texted me a picture of a biscuit. Oh, wait, no, it's chicken in a biscuit.
Yes. That's what I've been saying to you for the last 10 minutes.
I can't fucking understand what you're saying, man. Oh, my God.
Are you now looking at a picture of a box of chicken in a biscuit crackers?
I'm looking at it because somebody just texted it to me. Nicolette, my head of operations at my label, just texted me a picture of chicken in a biscuit.
Nicolette, by the way, who I do want to give a shout out to. Here's what happened, Payne. This is how we got you on the show. I saw pictures of you playing Animal Crossing on Twitter. I thought, I got to get this guy on the show. He's going to be the breakthrough guest that's going to take us to the next level. And so far, that has proven to be the case. We are definitely, whether it's the next level up or down, I haven't figured that out yet, but we are on the next level.
Down, for sure. No question.
And so I reached out, I looked at your Twitter profile and it has an email for your management, this lovely lady called Nicolette. And I reached out to her. She said, let me take it to T-Pain, see what he says. Next thing you know, you're on the show.
Nicolette is awesome.
It was really that easy. And she's great. I feel like Nicolette, I feel bad for her and all your management, because like they sent me a list of stuff that they said you wanted to promote. And now you're here on the show saying you don't care about promoting anything. So I feel like I got to bring these topics up to make sure.
No, please don't. Maybe the song one. Let's get the song out of the way.
First of all, I got to talk to you about important stuff. I got to talk to you about Animal Crossing.
Okay, good. Let's go.
Okay.
Let's get serious for a minute.
T-Pain, tell me about your life in Animal Crossing. How's your island going? How are you enjoying the game? What's going on over there on T-Pain's island right now?
I will tell you what's going on real quick. Hold on 1 second, okay? Okay, so let me tell you about my life on Animal Crossing. Animal Crossing has completely changed my sleep pattern.
How so?
Once I found out that things change on the island at 5 a.m., I can't go to sleep before 5 a.m. now.
Oh my God, you're up all night playing this game?
I'm not necessarily playing it. I'm literally just sitting there watching it, catching butterflies, catching moths, fish, and stuff until 5 a.m. I cannot go to sleep.
What happens at 5 a.m.?
That's when it resets.
Okay. That's like the new day starts. Right. Okay.
The new day starts. So I can't go to sleep anymore before 5 a.m.
What do you like to do in the game? Are you terraforming your island? Are you working on having a beautiful house? Like what are your priorities on your island?
See, you're coming at the presumption that I have the terraforming tool.
Oh, you don't have that yet? Okay. KK Slider hasn't visited your island yet? That's what opens up the terraforming.
I just got my 10th islander.
That's what's going to open the door for you. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't met her yet. When I logged on today to come to the show, I got the whole announcement thing. And then I was like, I can't talk to anybody. I got to get to the airport so I can be on this talk show right now. And then on my way to the airport, literally everybody was like, yo, Payne. Oh, shit. Like, no, I got shit to do. Y'all motherfuckers don't talk to me not one time.
Wow.
Any other time I'm playing. But the second that I would need to go to the airport to actually do something, everybody wants to fucking talk. This is crazy, man. I got new people. The weed man is on my island right now. I got stuff to do. I got to leave.
Yeah. Yeah. He'll pay you double for weeds.
Yeah, I keep trying to sell this man weed and he
he'll buy it from you.
Yeah, he will, but I had to leave, and I don't know when he's coming back, but I don't know.
He's a man of mystery. He comes and goes.
I had the weed man on my island.
Have you invested in art yet?
Yeah, have you hooked up with Red?
I bought an art piece. I hung it up in my bathroom. I didn't take it to Blathers at all.
You just hung it up?
Yeah, I hung it up and I was like, you know what? I'll buy another one. And then boom, we'll be good. I'll just take that to Blathers. Cool. And then I took that one to Blathers and he was like, this shit, fugazi as hell. And I was like, well, I'm not going to take the one off my wall. So
you got to do what I do. Go to the website. The websites will tell you how to spot a fake. And that way you never get taken by Red.
I can't. Like, I want to experience the whole game like in real time. Like I try not to go, like my main thing I want to do right now is go to Nookazon.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Leah B. Jackson, who works at Riot Games, she's like our prop master, and she basically gets the items for everyone who works at Riot Games. And she now works with my wife, who's also called Leah, via Nookazon to make sure that like our wardrobe department is, we buy everything at Able Sisters every day. We get every prop in the game. Like,
I guarantee,
T-Pain, you know, you and I are Nintendo friends now, and I hope we stay that way.
Absolutely.
If there's anything you want in the game, hit me up and I can get it to you within 24 hours. I am now your hookup. I can get you anything you want.
I need everything.
I'm telling you, get ready. Your mailbox is going to be fit to burst.
I'm ready.
Stuff. I'm gonna have a lot of good. Anything you want, hit me up and I got it for you. I got it for you.
Perfect. I'm ready for it. But you know, just going through the motions. You know, it gives me something to do. If I'm not working on my car, if I'm not doing other stuff in my house, then you know, the Switch is in my hand. And you know, even if I am working on my car, in between letting parts cool off after I done grinded it to death and stuff like that. Right. Yeah, I'll definitely pick up the Switch and go. So this thing is not, it's not so much as taking over my life, but it's definitely enhanced it a lot. I can tell you that now.
Yeah, I mean, it's been a long time since I was so engrossed. And that's how this whole thing started. I started streaming the game every day because I was playing it every day. I figured, well, I may as well stream. Next thing you know, I got a late night talk show.
Exactly. And this happened to me with a couple of different games, but not so much as, you know, after I pick up the game for a while and play with it for a while, and I just let it go. But this is a game I don't think I'm going to be able to just let go like that.
Right, I hear. You know, I mean, you know, I'm already looking forward to like Halloween, Christmas in Animal Crossing. How sweet's that going to be? I can't wait for an Animal Crossing Christmas.
I think it's going to be joyous, man. As long as it's not snowing on my island because I got stuff to plant and stuff like that. I don't know. I don't know if they paid attention to that much detail to where certain things don't grow in the snow. But I just really hope I make it that far, man, because I'm very particular about my island, and you know, Nintendo, don't fuck with me, man. Please let me finish.
Who are your favorite? Do you have any a favorite villager? A favorite neighbor on your island? Who do you?
I got usually, Marina.
Marina, who is Marina?
Marina, the pink octopus.
The pink octopus. Oh, yeah. Why don't I have that? That sounds amazing.
Yeah, she's dope. She's super fine.
Do you like her?
Yeah, nah, she dope in the face. She got that big old hole in the front of her face. It's pretty cool. God.
Do you have a villager? Now, most, I don't know what it is, but like, it's many people that I know, they always also have an islander that they don't like. Is there like anyone you want to get off the island? Because it's usually that one island, that one neighbor that annoys you.
Or
do you just get along with everyone?
No, I think Antonio's the guy. Like,
who's Antonio? Antonio's
the anteater that works out a lot for some reason.
Oh, I hate those jock personalities. They drive me crazy. All they ever talk about is their workouts.
Yeah,
like, get another hobby.
He definitely just gave me a weight set, though, like right before I got here. He was one of the people that tried to stop me before I got to the airport. It was like, yo, you need the weight set to get KK Slider here. And I'm like, I mean, cool, but you got to get the fuck out of here, man.
I gotta say, Payne, I typed into, we have a little text chat over here where I can talk to the producers and other people backstage. I typed into the chat a few minutes ago, this is already the best show we've ever done. I'm having the best time.
I appreciate it, man.
Not to disrespect any of my past guests, they've been great and they're all welcome back anytime. But you are absolutely on another level. I want to give you the opportunity because I have a new segment on the show here. I'm desperately, as Adam knows, the game, I love the game, but it also drives me absolutely crazy with some of the design choices and the interface choices.
Oh, really?
I feel like if enough celebrities come on this show and complain, Nintendo might actually listen and change some things. So, Payne, I want to give you the opportunity. If you could wave a magic wand and change one thing about the game that really annoys you, what would it be?
Oh, my God.
I'll give you an example. Like for me, it destroys me that when I go shopping in Able Sisters, I can buy a jacket, pants, and shoes, but I can't buy two jackets or two pairs of pants. I got to go in and out of the fitting room. What's that about?
Oh, really?
It's crazy.
Well, you know, I don't have Able Sisters yet, so.
Oh, that's right. You don't. Okay.
Yeah, I'm trash. So I think the one thing I would change. I think the one thing I would change if I can wave a magic wand and change something, if you know when you're on the directional pad, right?
Yes.
If you hit up, it shows you the tool wheel.
Correct.
But if you hit left and right, it just takes you to those things.
Yes.
I feel like if they were in order, I think that'd be a lot easier to where. If I know where my ladder is and I know where my pole vault thing and I know where my net is and things like that, if I knew what was coming next, that would help out a lot.
Yeah. The one thing that you can do is you can arrange the tools on that wheel like how you want them. So if you want the shovel to be like at 12 o'clock or the ladder to be 6 o'clock,
no,
you can do that.
On the wheel, it's fine. But when you hit left and right, they're not in order. I don't know if you noticed that.
Right.
They're not in order.
They're actually in order in the way they are in your inventory.
That's true. That you can actually move them around in your inventory, and that's how they will pop into your head. Giving you the tips. Giving you the hot tips on the show right now.
No. I want them in order how they are on the wheel, bitch. That is... That is not what I want. I want it. If you know somebody's easy ass way to get the shit off of the wheel, and then like, hey, but also if you want to get them another way, then fucking go to this other inconvenient ass way to get to them. Look, man, I just want to be able to be naked in the game. I think I'll be fine.
You want to be naked?
Mm-hmm. Or at least, you know, underwear, tank top, maybe that's it. Or at least no shoes.
I think you can do the tank top. If you just take all your clothes off, you'll have a tank top and shorts.
See, I don't want the shorts though.
I mean, you can do it right now if you want to strip down. I'm not going to stop you. Make some headlines.
Isn't that against the terms of service?
It is.
He's not going to be naked. He's going to be down to his grundies. Wait a minute. He's going to do it.
Maybe because
go into your wardrobe and just deselect everything, or like go into your little wardrobe thing, sure, and just take it all off. There you go. The crown. I think you should leave the crown off, but you're naked. Yeah, otherwise. I think you should have the crown. You should wear nothing but the crown.
Oh, naked face! I may have to put that back on. Let me.
All right.
Wrong thing. Wait. Wait. Does this work?
There you go. Oh! You're stripping down. There you go. You're getting there. Now take the pants off.
Let's start. Oh, wait a minute!
Now we're talking. You came on the show and we realized we made your dreams come true. This is what you wanted.
No!
Look at that. Look at those socks. Look at those socks.
This is it. This is the fit. All right, cool.
All right, I'm going to do the rest. You want to do the rest of the show like that? Okay.
This is it.
I do think you should put the crown back on.
That's what I wanted the most. Hold on, wait a minute. That's not that. That's not it. That's not it. Okay, cool. Cool. All right.
You know, I don't like to call this out, Adam, but we did break an audience record just now on the show. We are over 14,000.
Let's go!
It's a new record. Payne is taking us. We're moving on up. Payne is taking us to the next level.
Let's go!
I love it. I love it. Oh my god. Payne, we got to check the boxes. I got to ask you about what you're up to. Listen. I heard.
Do you have to though?
Let's do this one thing, because I don't want to get an angry call from Nicolette. She's so nice. I don't want to make. She's been so nice to me.
She's
a great.
Nicolette, do it for her. The best thing that's happened in my career.
Do it for her.
Okay.
Listen. Payne. Nicolette told me that you recently.
I feel so naked without a beard. Does anybody have a beard laying around?
But you know the game doesn't do beards well.
I had a beard though. I had a rounded beard. Does anybody have a rounded beard just like chilling? Nobody?
No, not in my inventory.
Damn it. Sorry, my God. What? I grabbed
you
know, the
Xbox. We'll get you a beard. I will send you a beard in the mail. Don't worry about it.
I mean, I have one. It's just like, you know, on my island. Go ahead. Keep going. Go ahead. Do your thing.
Okay. So, Payne, Nicolette told me that you recently basically went completely independent, no record labels. You started your own record label, Nappy Boy Entertainment. Tell me about that. Why? So you, it was just like a kind of like, you just didn't want to be part of the corporate thing. You didn't want to work for a label. You wanted to have your own label and be your own boss. Was that the thing behind it?
From being in this game for 15 years, I feel like I've kind of witnessed the positives and negatives and everything possible in between. So, you know, it was like, why pay more people to do the things that I know how to do right now?
My feeling exactly. You know what I mean? That's why I do it all myself here on Animal Talking. Why do I need to pay these bozos?
This is why this thing is so perfect. Because you don't need other people. You don't need too many chefs in the kitchen. Like, this is amazing. Like, it's the same thing with me, man. I don't need too many chefs in the kitchen. I feel like I know what I want to do. If it doesn't work out, then at least I'll be able to blame it on me. You know, because you see every day, especially in the urban demographic and the urban genres, you see people like, oh, my label's holding me back. Oh, my label won't let me release this, blah, blah, blah. I don't have anybody to blame.
I love it. There's nothing like being your own boss.
I've always said to my managers, to my label, I've always said, and they can attest to this, I've always said, if something fucks up in my career, let me be the one that fuck it up.
I hear it. I'm hearing you.
And this is the ultimate version of that. So I can't blame anything on anybody. If something goes bad, it's on me. If something doesn't work out, it's on me. But also, if something actually works, I actually know that my ideas were great, like I was thinking in the first place. So this is the ultimate exhale. This is the ultimate. I know I was right this whole time.
So Nappy Boy Entertainment is a thing. You dropped your first single last month, Wake Up Dead. That's out right now. You've already signed 5 artists across all different genres, hip hop, pop, R&B. You're the CEO. You get involved with each artist. It feels like you're on the way to becoming a hip hop mogul. Is that what you want to do? You want to be a hip hop mogul?
Mogul is a weird word. Not only is it just hard to say, but it just brings on. It's been tacked to a couple people that I don't want to be tacked to. You know, okay. it's like some people use that word and it's like, that's not what being a mogul is. So I would just say, you know, a businessman, a great artist, and an artist that knows what an artist would love and things like that. I don't think mogul is a great word for me, especially now that I'm just now figuring things out and starting my own label and really getting with my artists and stuff like that. I'm just at the beginning of it, but I just think I'm just an artist that knows what artists want.
So what is your ambition for the label and for you personally? If you don't want to conquer the rap world, from a business standpoint, like is it more of an artistic ambition that you have? What is it you want to achieve?
I think my ambition is more of letting people be heard that would you know, on the other side would not be heard. Right. I think it's a coalition of people that wouldn't be given a chance because they're so different. And that's exactly how I came up. You know what I'm saying? Like, as far as, you know, me using the auto-tune and me coming different and I wanted to be different than everybody else and nobody taking a chance on me like that, except for Akon. And you know what I'm saying? When Akon heard it, it was like, this is different. I want to take a chance. So I want to be the Akon to, you know, all the artists that I'm signing right now. I want to be the people that like, I like your sound. I know you can't really get across right now to anybody else, but I like your sound and I want to push it out.
So I'm liking what I'm hearing. You obviously have already achieved tremendous success, right? Your success is already like at the level that anyone would want it to be at. I don't know what Adam's doing running around. Will you stay in one place, please? You're just distracting me.
I'm
trying to interview a hip-hop superstar right now and you're running around like, what, I don't know what's going on. So now you've achieved that success. It sounds like what you want to do is kind of pay it forward and kind of looking for beard. Are you watching this? Trying to conduct an interview here. This is supposed to be a professional show. I swear, I am so close to fire. Every show I am this close to firing Adam. This close.
He was this looking close. For a beard, though. I did ask for a beard. That was pretty cool.
We found one. And
we could have got it for you after the show.
Is it a goatee?
It's a goatee beard-ish thing.
Yeah. Like I said, the game does not have great beard options.
I had that rounded beard though. That pretty much made my character.
Yeah, I thought it looked good. I thought it looked good. I thought the VR goggles are a very good look for you too, frankly.
You know what? I'm just gonna, just real quick. I'm gonna just.
Are you gonna slip it back on? What are you gonna do?
I'm just gonna just real quick.
You got a full inventory there?
I don't.
When he came over for the soundtrack, I tried to give him his show gift. He couldn't pick it up because he came over with a full inventory.
I had a whole thing.
You gotta organize your shit, T-Pain.
Oh man. Oh, where's my...
What are you doing? What is he up to?
Where's my mask? I at least had a mask.
Yeah, it's in there somewhere.
Yeah, you did. It's going to be in your inventory.
It's not though.
It's got to be. It can't be anywhere else. Now we're talking.
Okay, this was a little bit better.
All right. Okay. That looks good. Okay. That looks good. Okay, so Payne. After I was so rudely interrupted by Adam, let me get back on track here with this interview. It sounds to me like, and I like this a lot, what you're doing. You've already achieved tremendous success for yourself. But now that you've got this platform in the music industry, it sounds like what you want to do is kind of reach back and help other artists who are now where you were before you were famous. And you're gonna give them a leg up and help break new talent into the industry. Is that what
Absolutely.
You're now interested in doing?
Absolutely. It's a reach back to where it's like, I know you're misunderstood. You know what I'm saying? People that are usually like super good at what they do are usually misunderstood, and they're usually like weird people. But I try to reach out to those people and let them know that somebody absolutely understands you, and somebody's gonna make sure that you get your just due.
Right. I think that's great. I think that's wonderful what you're doing. That's very it's very human. Like, it just feels like a very human thing to do. Is like, you don't think like you've got the success, and you don't think about, well, how can I become even richer? How can I become even bigger? It's like, what can I do for other people who are looking for that big break? I think that's wonderful.
Exactly. It's not about like, I've achieved everything I wanted to achieve. The only thing that I like have left is to put somebody on, like, on a national or international level, and to sit back and make money at home. That's the only two things I want to do in my life.
Well, right. I mean that's exactly what I do with the turnips every week. You know, I go buy my turnips from Daisy May. I like.
By the way, what are your turnips selling for? Because I got.
Well,
I got
so like, you know, because I'm a celebrity, because I'm an internet influencer, because I'm a famous late night talk show host.
Right.
I can buy my turnips on a Sunday morning. I lay out about 350, 375K. And then by Tuesday, I've got, because people want me to grace their island with my celebrity presence. They offer me like 500, 600. Like this week, I think I sold for 588. In 48 hours, I turned a $375,000 Bell, $375K Bell investment into like 2.3 million.
Oh my God. Okay. Right now, I got like 900. Turnips sitting in my house right now, just
You know what? Here's what you got to do, Payne. You got to get with me. I'll give you the inside track on the hot dodo codes for the turnip prices.
Hot dodo codes.
Everybody wins because this is what happened with Elijah Wood, who's coming on the show tomorrow night, by the way.
Elijah, come on, let's go.
Let's just drop this right now. Tomorrow night on the show, since we brought it up. Danny Trejo, Elijah Wood, and Greg Grunberg will all be here live on the show tomorrow night. We are killing it on the show tomorrow night.
So you're immediately going more famous right after me.
Oh, yeah. No. We've peaked.
I'm going to be special for exactly one night. This is good.
Yeah, we got Frodo, Machete, and Snap Wexley on the show tomorrow
night.
Yeah, It's going to be big.
So what happened,
I don't know if you heard the story, Payne, but this kind of went viral, and this is why Elijah's coming on the show. He plays Animal Crossing. He's playing it on the DL. He's not making a big deal out of it. Someone on Twitter says, hey, I've got a great turnip price. You know, DM me if you want a dodo code. Elijah Wood slides into her DMs. Can I come to your island? She sees the verified account, Elijah Wood. Oh, my God, of course you can come over, Elijah Wood. Why wouldn't you? He comes over, is unfailingly polite. He's so lovely. May I pick some flowers? He's just so sweet. She's freaking out because Elijah Wood's on her island. This ends up on CNN. It's a big deal. Oh my God, Elijah Wood's the sweetest guy. He plays Animal Crossing. He's super polite.
Right.
And it's like a whole thing. So we reached out to him, and he's coming on the show tomorrow night.
That's more testament of how right you're doing this, man.
That is some John Krasinski good news type shit. Like, that's what we want on the show.
You're doing a great
That's
job,
the energy man. I want. This show is wholesome. It's family entertainment. I mean, not right
it's
now.
It's amazing.
But usually
because,
it is.
No, it's not. But you're doing great when like people come on and have nothing to promote. Like they just want to be here. They want to be in this capacity. So.
And that's the thing. And I'll tell you. Let me tell you, Penny. This is how real we're keeping it over here. I'll tell you exactly what I tell everybody.
Whether
I approach them. Or they approach, I swear, if I told, Adam knows, if I told you some of the people that want to come on this show or are coming on the show, you would freak out.
Freak out more than he's already freaking out?
Oh, yeah, big time. Alexandria, Ocasio Cortez, you know,
go back. Don't slip past that like you just said something weird. What did you just say?
Alexandria Ocasio Cortez is coming on the show.
I'm gonna punch you in the face. I'm gonna punch you in the face.
Punch you in the face.
Your excitement, of course.
Punch me in the face just yet because it's not confirmed. But I am talking to her. I am actively talking to her people, and we are working it out. It's the dates. It's scheduling. She's very busy. I'm very busy. But we want to make it work. We're gonna try and make it work, and it's gonna happen soon.
Crazy.
Yeah.
What are you? Oh my god. Okay. That's
There's a couple of other names I want to give you, but I can't do it on the show. I will tell you after the show who else is coming on, and you're going to shit. You will.
I don't want to shit.
You might. You might.
I don't want to shit. What? Is that the consequences of hearing?
But I will tell you. I will tell you what I've told everyone who has said to me, "Well, what is the show like? Can he promote?" Because I'm talking to the handlers, right? The publicists, the managers. And they said, well, can he do this? He wants to promote this. Can he do that? Like, I had someone who wanted me to submit internet the questions ahead of time. I'm not doing that. That's not how we roll over here. I said, you know what? Let's not do it. And I walked away. The person in the negotiation who has the most power is always the one who's willing to walk away first. And I will always walk away. I don't care who you are. If I'm not feeling the realness, I'm walking away.
That's how you do it, brother. Trust me.
And so I've had people, the public said, such and such a person, you know, we might want to come on the show. Let me go. They answer a bunch of questions. No, you don't need your own Animal Crossing character. We can create one for you here. We use an app called Discord. Well, here's the thing. So you are the realist. You actually are controlling your own character on your own Nintendo Switch right now. But occasionally when we want to have someone on the show, but they don't have Animal Crossing, we actually create a character for them on this end here and control it from here.
Do you just provide the voice?
My preference is always the people that bring their own characters. But we do have a system to accommodate people that don't have their own characters.
They're weird people.
If you're not playing Animal Crossing right now, there's obviously something wrong with you. here's the line I use in every email, and I swear this is real. I always say to them, like, okay, let me go take it to whoever. I always said the name. Oh my god, let me go take it to whoever. And I said, okay, but tell him this, or just bear this in mind when you go to your celebrity client. If they need to be convinced or why this is cool, or it needs to be explained to them why this is cool, I don't want them on the show, because they're not right. You either get why this is cool or you don't, and that's all there is to it.
That's absolutely right.
Payne, you get why this is cool.
Absolutely. This is cool. Bro, the second that somebody told me somebody made a talk show in Animal Crossing, I'm like, impossible, but I would very much like to see that. And I'm here for it.
I had someone from the Guardian newspaper call me up last week, and I interviewed with them, and they did a piece on all the different things that people are doing with that. I mean, the talk show is just one thing.
Did you see the New York Post thing?
No, what was in the Post?
It was the whole thing. It was about everybody that's playing Animal Crossing. It's crazy.
Well, I don't know if this is of interest to you or not, Payne. I'm just bringing it up. In the Guardian, one of the things that's apparently very popular is there's a dominatrix in Animal Crossing, and you can pay her in bells.
Oh man!
And she will slap the shit out of you.
I was just going to say, it's weird that there's not Animal Crossing porn yet, but you just did it. Hey, can I ask you guys a big favor?
What's up?
Yes.
Can I do something that I do in my stream real quick?
Well, I don't know. What is it?
It's not bad. It's not bad. It's not going to get anybody banned or anything. I just want to do it real quick and just to, you know, to keep my tradition going.
But you're not telling me what it is. What is it?
It's not bad. Nobody's going to
get it. He does on his own stream.
Thing is, if you tell me what it is,
okay,
we're probably going to be in more trouble. So just do it on the QT. Whatever it is you got to do, do it. Okay.
Okay. All right. Everybody has to be quiet, though.
All right. Oh, my God.
Okay. You ready?
Adam, get ready to mute his mic.
You said be quiet.
No. You ready? Are we ready?
I don't know, am I?
Alexa, turn on everything.
What did he just do?
I just activated everybody's fucking Alexa.
I see what you just did. Okay. All right.
Okay, cool. All right. We're good.
That is good. Okay, that's good.
That's all I wanted. Everybody's listening to this out loud.
I had no idea what my imagination went to some dark places just then. I was trying to figure out what
I just wanted to make sure I activated everybody's Alexa. It's fine.
The other thing I want to talk to you about, I'm trying to get you back on track here, Payne. I also want to talk to you.
There's going to be none of that.
But this is cool, though. I actually think this is cool. I want to talk to you about Nappy Boy Gaming. Tell me about Nappy Boy Gaming.
Nappy Boy Gaming. You know what? Nappy Boy Gaming has been in the works, and I know this is hard to believe, since 2007. I've been gaming for so long, man, and I've been gaming for, I mean, as long as I can remember, obviously, because I'm talking about, you know, Lion King and Battletoads and Toe Jam and Earl and stuff like that. But I, you know, every time my manager sees me doing what I'm doing, you know, or when I had a manager, but they would always say, do people know you do this? And I'm like, no, this is like part of my private life. Like, this is just something that I just do when I'm not being in front of the camera and stuff. And everybody would always say, people need to know that this is a thing you do a lot.
Right.
Now, right. I don't think people need to know how trash I am at video games, which is not helpful to anybody. But
I know I'm telling 17,000 people, by the way, it's 17,000 people right now.
Yes. Yeah. Listen,
I don't know about you, Payne, but like when I boot up a video, like in June, right, I'm going to boot up The Last of Us 2. There's going to be a screen that says select your difficulty mode. Every time, baby ass baby mode. Every time. Give me the easiest mode in the game. Give it to me. Easiest. Not just easy, very easy. Give me the easiest mode.
No, but I mean, we all want that little bit of challenge.
I don't have the time to fight the same boss 20 times. I just want to get on
with
it.
We all have that time. We all have that time now.
I used to have time before this show came along. It's a distant memory now.
you want the story mode. But no, I think...
Yeah, I just want to experience the story.
I mean, some games have trash stories, though. What are you going to do about that?
Yeah, but The Last of Us, I don't play the games with the trash stories. I play the good ones.
You don't know which ones?
Do you appreciate story? Do you like your video games to have a good story?
I do like video games to have a good story. I like everything to have a good story. Sometimes my wife likes to like things to have a good story, but also she wants to tell me six of her stories from high school when we start a new show, and then. I like good stories, man, but you know, it's about the what's coming after the story, like what right. Is it about your shit transitions into the battle scene after the story, or
is it
just like 90% story? You know what I didn't like? Oh my god, and a lot of people are gonna hate me for this.
What
I didn't like the latest Metal Gear Solid.
Which was the most recent one? Five campaign.
It was a five. Campaign? Yeah, five.
Yeah.
I couldn't do
you
it.
You have offended me.
You know what? I knew that, but I will tell you this: at the beginning of it, when you start playing it, every 5 feet, it's another cinematic. I can't. Right.
Yeah, Hideo, he loves his cinematics.
You're not wrong.
I just can't. Like, I haven't even started the first, like, the tutorial levels of that game is astronomical.
And a lot of people in the chat are agreeing with you right now.
I get it, but it's like, bro, I've played the other 1,000. Like, let me play this game, please. Yeah. Yeah. Every five steps you take, it's another cinematic, and I didn't get past the whole hospital, the getting out of the hospital thing. I don't even know what happens
it's my job, right? I'm a screenwriter. I write stories. I write stories for video games. I love storytelling in video games. I don't like when people skip through the cutscenes. I think you should, you know, experience the story.
I don't skip past them.
But I was gonna say some games can overdo it though.
Oh my god. And let me tell you which one does it.
let me ask you this. What was the last game that you like that you felt had a great story and really sucked you into the storytelling?
The Fallen Order, man.
Oh yeah, Fallen Order. Yeah, they did a good job of that. Well, my buddy Matt Mignovitz, who worked with me on Star Wars Rebels, helped write that story. Good people.
Don't flex on me like that.
I gotta flex. I gotta do the celebrity flex.
That was crazy. You flex crazy.
I got to do the Star Wars flex.
No big deal. Gary knows the Star Wars guys.
I know them all. They're all my buddies.
Star Wars himself.
Not only was it a great story, but you know, with the voice acting, the motion capture, everything in that.
Respawn, they don't play.
Respawn does not fuck around. I'll tell you what they do fuck around with. Apex Legends. Stop the shit, guys.
You like Apex? You don't like Apex?
Yeah, it's not the fact that I don't like Apex. It's that I'm just so trash at it.
Yeah. Yeah.
I would like everybody else to be as trash as me, but it's like every time I log on, it's like, why the fuck am I so bad at this game?
Yeah, it's tough because everyone's a pro. Everyone's like a 12-year-old kid that's playing 16 hours a day. I can't keep up with that. I got a job.
Everybody that's in the regular mode is just running scrims for ranks. Don't come in here. What are you doing in here?
You know the one I'm really enjoying right now, Payne. You got to squad up with me. Let's get into some Call of Duty Warzone. I'm loving that game right now.
Bro, I played Warzone. That's the game you got to get into. 4 in the morning last night.
You played till 4 in the morning.
I played Warzone till 4 in the morning last night. It was the most exhilarating thing. I mean, I always play Call of Duty, obviously, but I play with my Canadian buddies, and I say that very proudly because I know at least 4 people. In Canada, so suck a butt, everybody. Oh,
yeah. Hey, you know Adam's
now you know
Canada.
Another one.
Adam's from Canada.
Really?
And Kate, yeah. Our wardrobe supervisor, is from Canada.
Oh my God! Everybody's from Canada.
Oh yeah, I'm surrounded by them. I can't get rid of them.
Six Canadians, you know.
I'm coming out of the walls.
Oh my God! I know a lot of people from Canada now, but yeah, so I played with my Canadian buddies last night, and. You know, we had a great time. We played till 4 a.m. We got no wins. Not one. Not
have
one
you,
win.
Have you not yet had a win in Warzone? Because I'm still waiting for my first. Second was the best I got.
Since it came out. I've only gotten a third.
Yeah, second's my best. And like, second is almost worse because like, it's so close to that victory. We didn't quite get it.
I think I'm the one that actually fucks up the whole squad because anytime I'm not on the squad they always text me like, bro, we just got like 4 wins, and yeah. I feel very sad, and it makes me super sad, but yeah, other than that I think, you know, Warzone is actually pretty goddamn cool, I'm not gonna lie.
No, I really like the gulag when you get tossed in the gulag and it's like I'm two of you in there and only one of you is getting out alive.
I'm big trash. I don't But the crazy thing is, I'm crazy good at gun game.
Oh, what's gun game?
It's a good one. It's a good one.
I don't know that. What the hell is gun game?
Feel free to explain.
I thought I knew them all.
So gun game is when everybody gets the same. Oh shit! My bad. I'm coming.
You can walk around.
No, this is good.
Do what you gotta do.
So gun game is when you when everybody starts out with the same weapon. And every time you get a kill, you move to the next weapon. And everybody gets the same weapon.
Okay.
So, you know, everybody's got the same. It's nobody's like, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter your rank. Doesn't matter what blueprint you have. None of that. Everybody gets the same gun. So
is that on PC? What is that on? How do I play this game?
I mean, it's a part of Call of Duty. No, it's Call of Duty.
Oh, it's
just the mode in Call of Duty.
I've never heard of it. This is all new to me. I'm learning something new.
It's a Call of Duty.
I've got to get in on it. I've got to get in on the gun.
It originated as a, if I remember correctly, a Counter-Strike mod that we used to play many years ago.
I will never and have never, will never, don't even think about it, will never play Counter-Strike.
No?
No, because there's like 60-year-olds that have been playing this shit since they were 13. Oh,
yeah. They'll just straight up murder you in that game.
No question. Yeah.
That's why I stopped playing PUBG, because everyone's a stone cold killer. And I'm just target practice.
No question. I can't do it, man. It's PUBG better than, you know, any other kind of battle royale game. But at the same time, it's like, why would I subject myself to just dying a bunch?
I mean, that's actually how I started my Twitch streaming career, such as it is. I was playing PUBG, and nobody ever wanted to watch me play because I was terrible at it. I saved it. One of these days, Adam, I'm going to do a show where I'm just going to force everyone to watch my PUBG
see you play when you're terrible.
What's that?
I think more people want to see you play when you're terrible.
I mean, based on my viewership, that's not the case. I've been there. Oh, I've been there. You want me to pull a PUBG clip right now? I'll run one. Don't dare me to do it. I'll do it.
Please. I would love that.
I'm going to find a clip for you right now. I'm going to make you watch it.
I would love that.
I'm going to find a clip for you right now. Let me find a good one.
Wait a minute. Do you have a widescreen in your
I got two screens. It's like it's like the Batcave over here, T-Pain.
Is it?
I got two. Well, no, not really. It's more like a sad office.
Did you see my last? Did you see my last Instagram post?
No, I posted it on the gram.
I posted it right before I got on. I got on the stream right now.
I've actually got now. You know what I've got? I've actually got your Instagram.
Looking at it, Adam?
Ready to drop right into the chat right now. Nappy Boy Gaming.
Is this where you are?
That's where I am right now. Yes.
God damn. Jesus. I thought my setup was ridiculous.
God damn.
Did you just post like a picture of your studio or something? Where's the image?
This is the picture.
Is it on Nappy Boy Gaming?
Because
I'm not seeing it.
Here,
no, it's
I
on
will
T-Pain.
Send it
it's
to you,
T-Pain.
Gary.
Send it to me in the Discord. I got to see it.
It's on T-Pain. I should have posted it to Nappy Boy Gaming, but I wanted more people to see it, so it's on T-Pain.
All right, if you send it to me, I can put it up on the screen. Okay, Leah. Okay, Leah's
put it in the chat.
Leah's already got it. Oh shit! This is your setup.
That's my game room. That's where I am right now.
I mean, I wish I could make it bigger. I can't zoom into it right now.
Hold control and scroll up.
Oh my god! This looks like ESPN or something. What's going on?
I got a lot going on in here, man. This room is huge. That's what I'm saying. Okay, see, okay, bam. See the wait. Put it back.
You want to go back? Hold on.
Put it back.
Yeah, I can't make it bigger.
No, that's it. Okay, see the wide screen on the right?
Yeah.
That's where I am right now.
Oh, my God.
Now, every time y'all ask me to do something on Discord, I got to go to that joint on the left, which is not an arm's length
at all. This setup is insane. What is that, like a 30? How wide is that monitor? What even is that?
That's a 49-inch ultra wide.
Oh, my God.
Oh, that Samsung, eh?
Yeah, the Samsung. And I got that. Nice. I got that in three of my game rooms. Well, that sounds like a flex.
That is insane.
Payne, can I come over?
Absolutely. Come on, man. Fucking hug and kiss everybody. Let's have a COVID party, bro.
All right. I'm gonna turn off the jukebox for a second because I'm gonna make you watch this PUBG video. It's 30 seconds long. God. This will give you a good example of the quality of you used to watch me play PUBG. This is a good example of the quality of the play.
How many interviews I wish I could have in a tank top and fucking boxers, bro?
And your socks and wearing a crown and a mask.
And a crown.
Again, do you think Colbert's going to let you do this? Because I'm telling you right now,
not even a little. That's suit territory. You got to have a full suit.
Yeah. No, we keep it real around here. We're not.
I mean, guys, at this point, I'm not going to lie. I'm feeling a little self-conscious. I would very much like if you guys could also, come on, guys. Let's strip it down.
Well, I can't. I'm the host. Adam is going for it. Adam's going for it.
Let's go.
Why not? I mean, why not?
I feel like you can. Okay. Absolutely.
I got to keep it real, but
as the host,
of that goddamn chair.
We'll see. Maybe things get a little more loose as the evening goes on. We'll see. I'm going to show you this clip, and then I got to bring it. By the way, I feel so bad for my poor friend Chastity Vicenzio, who's waiting backstage. She's got to be back there thinking, how do I follow this? Like, how
fucking
does
Adam
follow
man.
This?
Adam is the goddamn. You're the king, Adam.
Thanks, buddy.
You killed it.
Don't. Go to his head. It's going to go to his head.
It's
I'm going to show you this 30-second clip right now. We're going to go to the clip.
Oh my God! What are we doing? No! No!
What is this?
No!
What is
no.
This?
No. No. No.
Oh, is this PUBG?
No. 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 No.
Why? Why? Why?
No.
It's almost blue.
No. 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 No.
You're doing great. This seems like normal.
Yes.
That was fine. Just get to the circle and we can heal up.
That was amazing.
You saved it.
So, you know, you get the idea. I mean, that's probably one of the best clips I have. That'll give you an idea how bad my clips are. Here's how bad it was at PUBG Pain. I played the game for like a year. I got like 30 kills in a year. And I was so happy with each one. I saved it to YouTube and I made my wife watch it. I was like, you got to watch this. I killed someone in PUBG.
That sounds like my Apex record. Like for real. Not gonna lie.
Oh yeah, I mean like the kills are so rare in the game,
and so rare and far in between, like a lot. Like you just don't. I mean, because I look at people like Nice Wig, No co puffs. Like I look at people like that, and it's, bro, like kills every like minute or so. Like,
do you follow esports, Payne? Does that world interest you at all?
It does. It does. I only follow like my teams.
Okay, who like, are your teams?
The way that people, literally anybody from Florida.
Okay.
So the Mutineers on Call of Duty right now. Who was the Florida team on Overwatch for a while?
I don't know. Who's the? I don't watch any of this crap.
You don't? Oh my God!
I don't like esports. It's not my cup of tea. I understand that people like it.
It's not Overwatch. Overwatch esports was my shit. Well, the good
Florida Mayhem. The Florida Mayhem.
Florida Mayhem. Yeah, I fuck with Florida Mayhem for a while. The guy that started esports. Me and him used to own a strip club together in Miami.
What? This is my face for the rest of the show now. it's gonna stay this way.
So the guy that started esports, the guy that's really progressing everything, me and him used to own a strip club in Miami back in like, oh fuck, man. It was like 09, 10, 11. So we you know, Miami was a hot spot for me for a while. I used to live there, and the guy that I ran the strip club with, Tobias Sherman, and then he just stopped doing that shit after we closed the strip club, and then he started doing something with golf, and then golf didn't work out, and then he was like, you know what, I'm gonna go into games, and now he's a fucking, like,
he's East Coast, oh my God.
Bro, like, this man just texted me a picture of his $100 million check from MGM to run an esports campaign from their hotel.
That's like, where the money. I guess like maybe I should get into it. This is where the money is.
Maybe.
You know, my friend Naomi Kyle, who was actually our first guest here on the show, she's a part owner of a team in the Overwatch League. So maybe I should talk to her and get in on this.
Yeah, you gotta figure this shit out, man.
I'm hearing you that you're anyone out of Florida, you want to follow that. But like in terms of the specific games, like, you know, the big esports games, like Overwatch, League of Legends, like what games do you like to watch in the competitive space?
In the competitive space, I mean, Overwatch is great. Valorant hasn't really
I mean that's the new contender, right? Do you feel like that game's gonna break through? Because it's a very crowded space.
Bro, I mean Valorant has a you know what? I don't know how to explain it. Valorant it's pretty much Overwatch / fucking what's the other game?
Counter-Strike,
yes. Overwatch / Counter-Strike and it kind of hit me with a try hard feeling. Mm-hmm. And it just seems like everybody.
Yeah, I'm hearing that. I'm not cool. I don't know. Maybe there are all kinds of differences under the hood, but when I look at Valorant, it just kind of looks like an Overwatch knockoff. I mean, is that just me?
No. It's an Overwatch / global offensive. It's not a knockoff, but it's taking everything that people say they like about a game and they're trying to put it into one thing, but you can tell that's what it is.
Right.
If they would have came organic and like, we'll upgrade it to be those things, then yeah, maybe. At some point, maybe at like 3.5 or 3.7 or something like that, then yeah, it'll be Overwatch.
And listen, you can't judge it too harshly. It's in open beta. You know, Overwatch is a totally different game than it was when it launched. These games evolved.
Yeah, but they went off the hinges immediately and was like, bitch, this is Overwatch and CSGO right now. This is it. Like, right, like 1.0, fucking 0.5, they damn near went there. So it's kind of, no pun intended, it's kind of offensive.
It's kind of I kind of feel like what these, and I'm not saying that this is what happened with Valorant, but I feel like what happens now is like someone wants to get into this space. They look what's out. Okay, people like this element from Apex. They like this element from PUBG. They like this element from Warzone. Let's kind of Frankenstein all the parts together and try and create like the best of all worlds. But I don't know. Then you end up kind of with a game that's kind of like everything and nothing. I don't know.
I think it's promotion and marketing budget. I always take that down to that because if you, okay, it's story time. You ready for story time?
I'm always. You know, I got to get to my next guest after this, but Payne, I want to hear the story.
All right, here's story time. So I went to work with Kanye in Hawaii.
I'm the one who's flexing.
Yeah, I just threw something out there.
Just dropped Kanye into the conversation.
Yeah, so I went to work with Kanye for 5 days in fucking Hawaii. Okay. That was the flex. That was the flex part. So I went to work with Kanye in Hawaii for 5 days. On 808s and Heartbreaks. So okay. He had me doing all the 808s on all the songs, and you know, not so much as the heartbreak part. He was so what he told me out of his mouth was 808s and Heartbreaks is my first album. It's T-Pain's first album, Rapper Turned Singer, because Rapper Turned Singer, T-Pain's first album, is all a bunch of love songs with a ton of bass in them to make them seem more hood and like, you know, nonchalant. So if Rapper Turned Singer, my first album, was a bunch of love songs with a bunch of bass in them, then that makes 808s the bunch of bass and Heartbreaks the bunch of love songs. But he told me that he's doing this thing, but you just don't know how to market that. So literally we can make the same thing, but whoever markets it the best is going to be the winner of this whole shit.
So it all comes down to the marketing.
It all comes down to the marketing. And I feel like if Valorant has more marketing than CSGO or Overwatch, which obviously they're never going to have more marketing than Overwatch.
Yeah, but I mean, look at something like Anthem. They marketed the shit out of this out of that game, but it was a lemon. You can't make people play a shitty game.
Oh my god, it was so bad. Anthem was so bad. Oh my god, it was such a mindfuck. But the presentation at E3 was the most amazing thing that anybody's ever seen.
Yeah,
mm-hmm. I agree.
So that was part of the marketing. Now we don't say we have to. Now Kanye didn't say he had to actually deliver a dope project. He just said the marketing had to be better and more people will look into it. Now, you only found out that Anthem was bad because you bought it and played it.
I hear you.
Yeah.
But at that point, we got your money, bitch. Like,
wow.
Like, what are you going to return a digital copy? No, bitch. No, we got it. It's over.
Wow.
So I learned from that, and I understand what's going on with that. So
I don't know why we should even bother booking future guests out. We should just have T-Pain on every night and just do a Gary and T-Pain show. Because he's laying down the law right now, and I am loving it.
I'm down, bro. Trust me. I'm here for it. Anything you need, I'm here for it. But
Payne,
get to your next guest. We'll talk about those after.
I'm going to ask you to get up off the couch and scooch down onto the other end of the couch to make room for our next guest, if you'd be so good.
I'm not cool with that. I like the spot. This is really
you want to stay. I mean, you are wearing the crown. I mean, far be it from me to tell you where to situate yourself.
All right.
Okay, so the key to do this is to walk into the arm of the chair, and that will get you there. You go. Oh my god, what a pro!
Yeah, I'm there.
Come on. My next guest is a good friend of mine. She used to work at IGN. She currently works at GameSpot. She's done all kinds of other cool stuff that she's going to tell us about. Please welcome to the show my good friend Chastity Vicenzio.
That in the game.
Hello.
There she is.
Hey, everybody.
Oh, wonderful. Chastity, I'm so sorry that this is the act that you had to follow.
No.
I'm so sorry that took so long.
How in the world do I follow this?
You just got to ride the train. The pain train is still rolling. I'm just trying to hold on here.
You know what? You know what? You know
what? Get yourself up on that couch. You can do it. There you go.
There we go.
I'm going to put my clothes back on because this is obviously inappropriate.
Oh, yeah. This. Yeah, now, yeah, exactly.
Oh, no. I need to run.
Oh, my God. He's taking his clothes off. Okay. More under. What are you doing, Payne? Behave yourself, Payne.
I have a closed eyes emoji.
Do you have like a? I think we need some emotes.
I'm so sorry.
There we go. He's getting dressed. Put your pants on, Payne. Thank you. All right.
But then,
don't forget your crown. Don't forget your crown.
Okay, and then. I'm so sorry.
I love my crown. The crown is perfect.
It's
perfect.
It's so sweet. I mean, you really do wear it well.
Adam, you look great too. Gary, you look great. Everyone's very well dressed.
You don't need to address Adam. It's fine.
Oh my god!
If you have something to tell Adam, address it to me, and I'll pass it along for you.
Oh, you guys!
Because otherwise he's gonna get too. Otherwise you're gonna get too big. All these celebrities the last 2 weeks coming in and out of here. It's going to his head. I'm telling you, it's going to his head. Up in Canada, they don't have celebrities. He has no idea what's going on right now. He's so starstruck.
Adam knows everything. Adam's the one that's running this show.
He's the secret here. He's making everything work.
Chastity, I want to thank you so much. Chastity Vicenzio, I want to thank you so much for joining us on the show. And that goes double now, based on the previous hour and a half.
No.
No, I had a good time watching the show. I forgot that I was even on for a bit. I was just enjoying watching.
We kept you waiting so long. I wouldn't be surprised that you had forgotten.
My screen went dark like 5 times. I had to wake it up, but I was just really enjoying the stream. It was totally fun.
Okay, I want to get to you, and I want to get Billy on the stage and playing his music before we lose the front page at 9 o'clock, while we've still got 16,000 people in here.
They're not leaving.
I mean, some will leave when the front page rotates out, but what the thing is, it's Payne. who could leave this content, right? Where else are you gonna go?
Do not leave.
Nobody's leaving.
Where else are you gonna go?
No.
What are you gonna do, watch Ninja on Mixer? Come on, give me a break. You're gonna stick right here on this channel watching T-Pain on Twitch. That's what you're gonna do.
Gary's starting more beef.
I need those celebrity beefs. If Ninja beefs with me, that's only good for the profile of the show. You know he follows me on Twitter, right?
He does not.
Oh, God.
He does. Ninja follows me on Twitter.
That's a ghost account for sure.
I can't get him on the show though, because he's got that exclusive deal with Mixer.
Also, he's a dick.
You think Ninja's a dick?
Yeah, fuck that guy, man.
Why? What's he ever done to you?
A lot.
Oh my God. I'm so sorry.
The first thing you did to me is made it seem like Drake plays games. Like that.
Wow.
That was the first thing you did to me.
Now we're getting the realness. Oh my goodness. There's your headline. T-Pain starts hip hop beef with Drake. Over calls him a video game faker.
I can't do that.
Calls him an imposter.
I'll just say nobody's ever seen a controller in Drake's hand.
I don't want to start any beef, but I do because it's good for ratings.
Let's get this show started.
I just get it straight.
Okay.
It's obvious. Anyone in the chat right now can tell. Anyone that's listened to you for the last hour and a half. Oh, you know what? Thank you for pointing out that I do need to change. The Chiron here. I need to bring on live with special guest Chastity Vicenzio. Even though T-Pain is still dominating the conversation.
I'm not.
I'm done.
I swear to God.
No. Are you accusing Drake of being a fake gamer here on the show?
Have you seen Drake have a controller in his hand before or after that whole thing?
I mean, I'm not saying anything.
My balls, boy! Yes!
Wow.
Let's go. Does Drake have a cool channel?
Chastity, I've got to try and reassert control of this interview, this show. Chastity Vicenzio.
Just kick me out.
We're good. You have had, and are having, a
wonderful career in video games. You used to work at IGN. You now work at GameSpot. Tell me, Chastity Vicenzio, how you got into video games. Were you playing video games when you were a little kid?
Yeah. I started with the NES. When T-Pain, when you were mentioning Lion King and Battletoads, like those games were so hard. Oh my god!
Right.
Yeah, I started with the NES. Went to Sega Genesis after that. Nintendo 64, all PlayStations, pretty much after that. I was only allowed to have one console at a time, though. I think I had a Game Boy at the same time for Pokemon. But yeah, I've been playing for a very long time. I missed. There was like I had like one small hole in my. Knowledge for video games because I was in news for like 4 years and then I came back and then went into digital media and then yeah I started working at a place called Revision 3. I don't know if anyone remembers Rev 3 Games. So I worked there after news and I was super excited about it and Adam Sessler came on and I was working with like Anthony Carboni, Max Scoville, Tara Long and then after that, we all kind of moved on to different places. A couple of my friends from, it was then Discovery Digital Networks because Discovery bought Revision 3, went over to IGN and then they brought me over. I interviewed for like a couple jobs and I got the second one. Yeah, I did. You ever seen their Snapchat channel? I launched that Snapchat channel.
Yeah, for sure.
That's what Chastity does. She works at GameStop. She does a lot of their videos.
If you ever need to go back, I have like the game room I'm in right now. This is Game Room 1. I have a retro room across the hall. And then I have
a retro room.
NES, SNES. I have arcade systems with 3100 games. I got Atari, PS1. I still
Can we have a party?
Absolutely, get
out of
my party!
Oh my god.
When the lockdown lifts, Payne, I think we got to get over to your place. We got to get over there.
Yes.
I like that just so you can fucking get your times right. Greg,
hey, T-Pain, do you cosplay?
I cosplay a little. Yeah? Did you not see my Leroy?
No, I got to see it.
My Tekken 7 Leroy? Oh my god, somebody pull that up now.
If somebody wants to send me a link, I'll take a look at it. I don't even know what they're talking about.
Oh my god, Tekken 7.
Oh my god, yes.
The new character, the DLC, Leroy. Oh,
I love
my god.
Tekken.
I always wanted to cosplay Asuka because
she was my main.
Yeah, they finally made a black guy with dreads, and I was able to do something. I mean, obviously, could have did a quick little Overwatch thing, but still, you know, it was too popular. It was so
bad. Yeah.
All right. Let's. For okay. Sure. Oh, you know what?
I got it.
Oh my god.
You found it?
Holy. I gotta go to it. Payne. I'm going to it right now.
Let's see.
Damn.
Yeah. That's my god joke.
Damn.
Oh wow.
That is no joke.
Yes.
Yeah, I hired a tailor and everything for that. Like,
I mean, that is
on point. That is amazing.
Yeah, I had to go to the mall like my dude in the middle of the mall. It was crazy. It was a lot.
Hold on, I got to zoom in a little. Look at this.
Yeah, my wife had to like spray my beard. It was a lot going on. It was crazy.
My beard is not that great. It's not green. I mean, that is on another level. Chastity.
That's a very good job.
Chastity, I'm sorry.
It's her fault. She keeps bringing you into the conversation. I'm trying to make it about her. She keeps bringing you in. Chastity.
I love it.
Let's talk
about
this.
Is very backwards for me. I'm used to interviewing other people.
I know. Here you can sit back.
So
you can
relax.
You're on the couch. Yeah. I'm behind the desk. I'm wearing a suit. You're in good hands. Don't worry about
this
it.
This is good.
T-Pain next to you. You're among friends. Chastity, I mean, did you ever imagine that your career in video games would lead to you sitting on a couch in Animal Crossing next to T-Pain?
Absolutely not.
Because that is where this road has led you.
This is wild. I love this. Life is crazy, and this is the best. This is the best. I don't know.
It's
this is
insane.
I've hit
it's
a peak.
Insane.
Pretty sure I've hit a peak. This is great.
I had my moment.
I just
want to
flex that I do have the crown, though. So
The peak is going to be when we all hang out at T-Pain's house and have a video game party dressed in cosplay.
God. I can't wait. I got to start thinking about my cosplay right now. Who I want to go
as.
I'm going to fly everybody out. This is going to be
Oh my god.
I had that surreal moment the other day, Chastity, when I was talking to someone. I said, Danny Trejo is coming onto my Animal Crossing talk show to promote his new cookbook. And like, in that moment, I just caught myself and I said, that is the most ridiculous thing you've ever said in your life. And I love it.
That sentence didn't exist until you made the show.
No, but and by the way, Danny, who was on the island a couple of days ago for his sound check, is the absolute nicest. You know, in the movies, he's known for being this like tough guy, badass, ultimate, you know, killer.
Absolutely.
He's the sweetest teddy bear you've ever met in your life. And he genuinely loves Animal Crossing. He loves spending time with the animals.
He's also 2 feet tall.
He's little. He's got a big heart. That's what matters.
Yes.
Giant heart. He's also like, you know, when you see Machete and, you know, the dawn and dusk thing, you just think he's like a giant guy.
I liked him in Heat. Remember that movie, Heat, when he was one of the bank robbers.
Oh my God, he was in Heat.
Yeah, he's in everything. He's been in 200 movies.
I'm sorry. I'm going to stop talking. Chastity, go ahead.
Hey.
Chastity.
I'm talking to the chat. Hi.
Chastity, what do you do at GameSpot?
Oh, hey. So I'm a host and also one of the senior producers. So I run the entertainment team. So everything that we cover that isn't video games, I am in charge of the video team for that. So okay. We cover TV, movies, anime, wrestling, all that fun stuff. And we have a separate channel for that. So it's youtube.com/GameSpotUniverse. And so we get really nerdy about TV shows and movies. So like we just broke down Westworld. We're doing Rick and Morty right now. American Horror Story. So yeah, we get real in the weeds. We just like pick out Easter eggs and have a lot of fun. And we've got a podcast too, where we recommend shows for people to watch, which is super useful right now, I think, because everyone is just stuck at home. You were? Yeah, this is so wild. Like just 2 episodes ago, you were on and I was interviewing you, and now I'm on your couch with T-Pain.
I love saying this because it makes me feel like such a talk show host. I understand you brought a clip. I understand
you brought a clip.
It's a trailer.
If you can see what I actually look like, possibly.
Keep it down for the next 43 seconds. We're going to roll this clip.
There's a Gary Easter egg, too.
Okay. This is a weekly podcast where we recommend and discuss TV shows and movies, old and new, and sprinkle in the biggest news in entertainment. Think of us as your friends to get streaming recommendations from and geek out with.
The Mummy's the best thing ever.
Really Candyman screwed me up.
Ryan loved Justice League.
So who are we? We're the GameSpot Universe team. We make TV episode and movie breakdowns that populate our YouTube channel, GameSpot Universe. You'll hear us most weeks, but you'll also hear guests from our editorial team and games team joining us for future episodes.
What are your hopes for 4, since you love Matrix
1? I hope it gets canceled.
I think my love of Lord of the Rings isn't even about Lord of the Rings anymore.
There's only 2 good Terminator movies. Terminator and T2.
Hellraiser fans, rise up. It's our time.
This is You Should Be Watching.
All right, Payne, that seems like a podcast you might be into. Movies, anime, all kinds of cool stuff. The summer event you've got coming up, Play for All, where you're going to be a summer gaming celebration and charity effort where you're going to be raising money for COVID-19 relief efforts. Tell us a little bit about what's going on here.
Yeah, so it's called Play for All, and it's starting in June. So as you know, there's no E3 this year, but we just want to let everyone know that we still got them covered. So it's a multi-week event, and you're going to get all the latest gaming news, previews, features, and interviews, but we're also partnering with Direct Relief to raise funds for healthcare workers who are risking their lives daily on a COVID-19 relief effort. So we're going to be hosting daily charity screams with special guests from around gaming, movie, and TV industries. So that includes our friends at Giant Bomb, Kind of Funny, NoClip, your friend Naomi Kyle, my friend Naomi Kyle, and more to be announced soon. We've got a lot of cool stuff in the works and some great guests.
That's wonderful. Stay tuned. Hey, Payne, let's hear you talk some shit about that. I thought that's pretty cool.
No, it's really cool. I actually want to be a part of that. I'm not going to lie to you.
Let's get T-Pain on the summer event. Let's do it.
Only
if I can be naked.
In Animal Crossing.
For the people backstage, let's get Billy ready to go. Let's get him mic'd up. Let's get him. He's going to perform.
Go!
I want to get him on here before we lose the front page in 10 minutes. But I do want to show this little clip because I do think it's cool. Chastity, you got to realize a dream recently when you were one of the onstage hosts for Star Wars Celebration. I know that you love Star Wars.
Oh, my God!
Star Wars Celebration Chicago 2019, in the before times where we were still allowed to congregate in public spaces. I'm going to run this video right now.
Give a big Star Wars celebration. Okay, welcome to our other like Star Wars show live co-hosts, Max Scoville and Chastity Vicencio.
Whoa!
It's shaking.
Shh.
shots!
So many emotions right now.
Yeah, that was incredible. Hi, everyone.
Hey.
Hello. Schittsburg, Pennsylvania.
Hey guys, Chastity, that's how I felt.
Star Wars Galaxy's Edge booth.
And I bet. Oh my god, it's crazy!
Which you can only it's terrifying. See
until today.
Hey guys, Chastity here at the booth terrifying. For Star Wars
Hey, you ever been to like a Star Wars convention or a comic book convention? I feel like you'd be in your element
Walt
there.
Walt Disney World and Disneyland.
I mean, I went to like when they started VR and stuff like that, but I mean, not this. God damn, this is amazing!
Oh yeah, this is cool.
Oh, yeah, shit!
I'm gonna come back. Chastity, I don't know if you're aware of this. I may have written a Star Wars movie, but you've actually got one up on me. Do you know I've never been invited to Star Wars Celebration?
What? That's not wild.
Once. No one's ever invited me.
You are the least cool person on
it's
the
not,
Star
you know,
Wars.
Like not, it's not that it's a sore point or anything.
No, that's pretty disappointing, man. I would feel like you need to... You got to get that together, man.
We got to get you for the next one.
I mean, but I'm kind of done. I worked in the Star Wars unit for 5 years. I'm not doing anything currently.
I don't think you wanted to see that, though.
Listen, I got to get Bill. So, Billy, T-Pain, I'm going to introduce you now. This could be your next artist on the Nappy Boy Records because you're going to love this.
Maybe. Hopefully he's not signed and
very recently, I discovered, well, not that recently, but a while ago, I discovered there's a tremendously talented musical artist, out of Christchurch, New Zealand, and he streams on Twitch, and what he does is he performs live. He plays like 8 different instruments, and in the Twitch chat they'll say to him like, mash up this song and that song, and he will spin gold out of anything. And so, you're gonna hear him right now. We're gonna bring him on. Please welcome to the stage, live from the other side of the world, Christchurch, New Zealand. Please welcome my friend, the very handsome Billy Mills. Look at that flourish. Look at that flourish. All right. This is it, Billy. This is your moment. You got T-Pain on the couch. Give us something. Take it away. Let's hear some of your music.
First of all, Billy.
Oh, yeah.
You are beautiful.
Twitch.tv/very handsome Billy. And in fact, what's going to happen is after the show's over, Billy's going to fire up his stream and we're going to raid his channel and it's going to be after party at Very Handsome Billy's.
Hey, why can't I do that with mine?
Come on. You didn't ask. You don't ask, you don't get. The squeaky wheel gets
I'm
the
asking now.
T-Pain. Hey, you just said earlier in the show that you're all about helping out young emerging artists. This is a young emerging artist.
Turn the camera to me.
Oh my God. Do I have to do this? Hold on. All right. Let's get the camera on him. Yeah.
What's up? Ladies and gentlemen, I have a Twitch channel. It's been active since 2014. My Twitch channel is twitch.tv/T-Pain. And also, you can suck a butt.
All right, Pain. Please, I would like to invite you now to kindly step off and allow the very talented, very handsome Billy to take the stage. And I promise you, he's going to wow you. He's going to blow your mind.
The boy has already done it. I'm cool with that. I just wanted to say one thing. That was it. Thank you.
We're good. T-Pain, you can now sit back and relax. Billy's going to take it away. Please, take it away. Billy. Very handsome
Billy. You guys, my name's Billy. This is an original song. Everything you're about to hear, I'm kind of live looping, making it up as we go. This song's called Sunshine.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Say, I'm chasing my own tail. Oh, and I just don't go anywhere in these walls, anywhere at all. Yeah, and I just don't know. Filling little cups takes time. Peace of mind is
walk around these halls no more. But in a moment's time, I'll be back in my brain, thinking about all the times we spent together. Oh, I remember, and I'll wait for you again. Cause feeling a little close takes time. Peace of mind is so damn hard to find. Woo! One step at a time, taking turns to walk in the sunshine. Yeah, ooh. I don't mind if you leave me alone.
Oh my God,
if you
so
leave
fire.
Me alone, just tell me when you're coming home.
Fire!
I won't mind, I'm holding my own. Oh, one, two, dip it, yeah.
Let's go!
Time, peace of mind is so damn hard to find.
How the fuck?
One step at a time, taking turns to walk in the sunshine. Yeah.
You motherfucker.
Oh my God. Oh my
you
God.
You motherfucker.
Ow.
What the fuck? Amazing.
That's exactly what you want to hear from T-Pain when you finish a song.
Damn!
T-Pain.
Oh my God, that was so good!
T-Pain, as the professional, as the music mogul, the billboard number one best-selling artist, we got to ask you, what did you think of that performance?
That was fucking amazing, bro. That was, I mean, oh my God. You got something to live towards, bro. You did it. You fucking did the thing. You did the thing!
Billy, come over and join us on the couch.
Oh, nice one, nice one. Am I sitting on T-Pain's lap?
I think you're gonna. I think you're. We're gonna do a little bit of musical chairs. There you go. There you go.
Oh, nice one.
I don't know if you're monitoring the screen, Billy. You are now sitting on the couch next to the almighty T-Pain.
Gary, if anything, I'm disappointed that we've both still got our clothes on.
I mean, I didn't want to go down
saying.
That road. I couldn't.
I'm
I can't
saying.
Stop T-Pain doing what he's gonna do. I couldn't stop T-Pain doing what he's gonna do. But like, is he gonna do it again? What's he doing? Oh my God! What's he doing?
This will be my screenshot. This will be my screenshot. Hey, what? Oh, what? No. It's just me.
Is everyone? Oh my God! Are you taking all your clothes off again?
Yeah. Here we go.
Here we go.
Yeah, it's more like
oh,
it.
Oh no!
Sorry, Chastity.
Oh, beautiful. PUBG clip all over again.
Go, baby.
No.
Beautiful.
Chastity, I'm so glad that you're staying out of this.
Yeah, Chastity, not good in this.
All right. Okay.
What's that?
Wait, hold on.
Good.
All right. Okay. Where did she go? Where is she? Oh, she's over there.
She's probably hiding.
Billy.
From...
Billy. I don't know how I discovered you, but I was trolling around Twitch channels and I saw this guy and I'm like, this guy looks interesting. He's playing instruments. And I saw what you were doing. You were interacting with the chat and mashing up different, you know, popular songs in real time. And I just thought it was incredible. And I've become a big fan of your channel. I've been visiting you ever since. You're super friendly. You're super talented.
Thank you.
How many... I'm talking to Billy now, Payne. Jesus Christ. Billy.
Yes, Gary.
Let me ask you this. How many instruments do you play, and how did you first get into music?
Well, so here's the thing. So I don't play a lot of instruments, but I will make it sound like I play all instruments.
T-Pain, from what I've seen, mate, you surround yourself with some incredible, incredible musicians. I just want to point something out now, but before I answer your question, Gary, T-Pain has a show, a thing online that's called the Tiny Desk Concert. Have you guys heard of the Tiny
Desk?
No, what
is that?
Yeah, it was really good.
Nuts. And you know, because you guys know T-Pain is that guy who's like shut a goddamn mouth. You know, you know what that kind of stuff, right? No, this dude can freaking sing. He can freaking sing. And he knows people as well. He knows people who can play their instruments so tasty. So tasty. And it's one of my favorite Tiny Desks. I mean, it's up there with Anderson .Paak, T-Pain.
All right.
I try.
Billy,
I just want to be very clear. I am asking this question to Billy. Billy, how many instruments do you play, and how did you first get into music?
Nice. So the my actual instrument that I'd honestly say I can play is the guitar. And I didn't actually play any guitar just then. I decided to omit that just for the sake of the
musical
style.
You played like six other instruments, right?
Yeah, yeah. I actually don't know how many instruments I do play. In this room, I can hang on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Oh,
seven,
come
eight.
On!
There's 9 or 10, but then there's also
a he's flexing, he's flexing.
I'm flexing. I've got
he's
a flute, mate.
He's flexing crazy. He's flexing crazy.
How did you come? Obviously, there are many musicians on Twitch, and we've had some great ones on. We had Raquel Lilly on the show, as you know. The Dapper Rapper is going to be on the show very soon. You're here now. You do something unique, though, right? The kind of live musical mashup thing. I'd never seen that before, and it's really cool. How did you kind of stumble into that concept?
Gary, I stumbled onto that concept because of people like you. Raiding my stream when I first started.
Come on.
But you know, you already had the concept. I brought some people to your channel, but you had the concept.
Dude, it started about a week before you came. Another gaming streamer started raiding me. That's the first time I'd ever been raided. You know, when you start streaming, you have about 3 people watching you. This guy brought in like 40 people, and that was huge at the time. and they just said, play this. And I just started playing it. And then I thought it was pretty average, to be honest, but they liked it, so I just kept on doing it. By the time you came around, Gary, I had it down a little bit.
You are super, super talented. You're going to go from a 40-man raid to something probably like right now there's 16,000 people in the chat. So you're gonna get a big raid. The channel has been growing. You're doing amazing stuff. Is your musical career limited to Twitch? I mean, are you dropping albums? Do you have a Spotify? Like, what do you want
to
do musically?
You have to,
dude. It's happened pretty quickly, so I'm not really sure. I mean, look, I'm sitting on a couch naked, with T-Pain. Do you know what I mean?
Again. Okay.
Do you know what I mean? So I'm saying it's all kind of all over the place. But I've been putting music out on Spotify that I kind of made myself. It's kind of been like a personal project, and now I've been showing it to people who have been coming into the streams. Right. That's really it. It's mainly on Spotify. I've started doing a bit of YouTube stuff as well, all that kind of stuff. But mainly, man, it's Twitch. I love hanging out with the community, and it makes me feel warm and welcome.
Can somebody drop Billy Spotify into the chat? There it goes. There's Billy Spotify.
There it is.
There he goes. You got to get on Spotify if you want to be taken seriously these days. Let's see. There it is, right there.
At some point.
Emails on Spotify.
Hey, that's me.
Nice. A lot of original music, a lot of mashups. Billy, I could talk to you all day, but like I want to get to the real reason you're here. I love what you do on your channel. I want to invite you. Excuse me, quick cough. I want to invite you to do what you do on your channel, on our channel. I'm going to invite people in the chat right now. Adam, if you'd like to vacate the band area and let a real musician get over there by those instruments, that I'd really appreciate that. Thank you.
Woo!
Thank you very much. Billy, I believe you're monitoring the chat. You're able to see the chat in our channel right now. If you have a popular song or a popular artist that you'd like to throw at Billy, he will mash them up in real time and create a musical magic, and we're going to get murdered on the copyright claims here, but I don't care because it's going to be so cool.
Make it happen.
All right.
Should we do this? All right. So you guys, here's what we're going to do. If you just list off any songs, any artists in the chat,
I'm seeing Pink Floyd. I'm seeing Elton John, Rocket Man.
I got one.
Go on, Payne.
If you say T-Pain.
I got one.
What do you got, Payne?
Let me lay something down, and I'll start taking stuff. We'll see where we go with this.
Okay.
I'm going for G minor.
I got one. You ready?
Okay, let's go, T-Pain.
What you got?
Let's hear it.
Because this is one that everybody's been asking for. Can I get I'm in Love with a Stripper?
Oh, my God.
What's that by again?
Let's say Sicko Mode.
Let's see if I can chuck some. Let's see if I can chuck some T-Painisms into the song. Let's see how we go.
Okay, let's hear it.
The second part of
the Do you have auto tune over there, Billy?
You know what? I actually don't. But I don't think a man should be defined by the auto tune that he chooses to use.
It's not gonna be a bad thing. So let's go.
All right,
I'm an auto tripper with sicko mode.
Oh my god! All right. Okay, Billy, give us what you got.
I've done it now. The crazy thing is I've done this, and it's working.
Here we go.
So, me.
Okay, what have we got in the chat, you guys? Let's go. Let's see what you got.
Woo! I'm seeing Pink Floyd, Rocket Man.
I'm seeing some stuff.
I'm seeing Elton John.
Oh, how about this?
Here come on, flat top, he come grooving up slowly. He's got juju, I believe one. Holy roller, he's got feet down to his knees.
I'm telling you, Kane, this guy's the man.
This is really good.
Yeah.
Oh, that's tasty. What else have we got? Let's keep going. Oh, yo!
Your heart don't stand a chance.
Woo! Oh, that's a banger.
Feels like it's been far too long. Yeah.
You gotta get some drums. Let's lay down a groove real nice. What kind of groove do we want? Something a bit broken. Something a bit broken. Let's do it. Oh damn!
Ooh. Oh yeah. You can dance if you want to. You can leave your friends behind. If they don't dance, well, they don't dance, and they're no friends of mine. You can dance if you want to. Leave your friends behind. And if they don't dance, and they're no friends of mine. They don't dance and well, they're no friends of mine.
There's so many coming through. All right, here we go. Okay, here we go. Drawing for Monkeys, I see yours. Bit of Pink Floyd.
We don't need no education.
Oh, shit.
Woo! I'll keep that bass groove, though, yeah.
We don't need no thought control.
Yeah.
No dark sarcasm in the classroom.
Woo!
Teacher leaving kids alone. Leaving kids alone.
Yo!
Oh! Shorty had them apple bottom jeans, boots with the fur. The whole club was looking at her. Shawty got low, 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 low. Leave them kids alone.
Damn!
Yeah!
Wow! Holy Jesus! That's amazing. That.
Hey, Payne, how do you like that?
No. I mean, I needed to bump with that shit in real life for sure.
I mean, that was pretty sick. Do you want to do some more, Billy? It's totally up to you.
guys, if we've got time, if you want to keep going, we'll keep going. Let's do this
because we've done the 2 hours. We've still got like 9,000 people in here, but like, why don't you mash up a couple others, and then when you're done, we'll wrap up and we'll raid your, and everyone can come over to your stream, and you can go, as obviously, you know, you go all night on your stream, so let's do it.
Yeah, okay, let's do it.
All right,
sounds like a laugh. Let's lay something down.
All right, let's do it. Let's do it. Black Hole Sun. I'm seeing people putting in there. I mean, you're looking at
Black Hole Sun.
You tell me.
I've got it.
Okay,
it's great. There's just so many songs. There's so many bangers. Let's do this. Let's give it a bit more tone like this. Something a bit more like. Oh yeah. There we go.
I like that.
Yeah, that's what we want. Oh, yeah. Also, how good is that reverb, right? You gotta chuck some in, like that. Just a bit of that. Here we go.
Okay, we're gonna go G minor on it, because T-Pain's a total G. All right, let's go.
Okay, all right. I like it.
All right, here we go. I'm just kind of humming along to try and figure out some melodies. Yeah. Woo! 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 Gotta get that shaker. Yeah. Oh, I remember when I lost my mind. There was something so pleasant about that face. Even your emotions have an echo in so much space. When you're out there, out of care, I was out of touch. But it wasn't because I didn't know enough.
Yeah.
I just knew too much. Does that make me crazy? Does that make me crazy? Does that make me crazy? Possibly. Oh, there's so many bangers. Oh my god. I need more. There's so many.
Too many. Hey, Billy, can you do Take On Me? That came in the chat. That's a favorite of mine.
Alright, go on then. I'll give you some harmonies.
Behind my back, and I'm talking to
myself at night because I can't forget.
You're getting involved. Whoa!
It's a collab. It's a Billy Mills T-Pain collab.
Yeah.
Hold the line. Love isn't always on time. Hold the line. Love isn't always on time.
More guitar, please. Oh!
I'm bringing sexy back.
Let's go.
Yeah. Them other boys don't know how to act.
Yeah. Yeah.
Special what's behind your back.
Yeah.
So go ahead and go pick up the slack.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you know what? I never thought I'd be on a boat. Some liquid water we rode. Never thought I'd see the day. Woo! When the big boat's coming my way. Believe me when I say I'm on a couch naked with T-Pain. Oh, yeah! Lord.
Oh, let's fucking go.
Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. Break it back down again. All right, what else have we got out there? What else are you guys feeling? I kind of like this vibe. I kind of like where we're at. What key
yeah, I like
G?
Where we're at.
G.
Let me go. Can't believe it.
This is tasty, man. This is tasty.
Let's go. Can't believe it. I don't want you to walk cabin. Let's do that. Let's do that. Okay.
Yo, dude, I want to hear you singing, man. Let's hear it. Let's go.
I can put you in a log cabin, somewhere in Aspen. But it ain't nothing to the pain in your land. Oh, oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh, oh,
oh, oh, oh.
A
bit of Britney when you get the chance.
Yes, please.
Oh, baby, baby, how was I supposed to know?
Wow.
Something wasn't right here. Oh, baby, baby, I shouldn't have let you go. Now we're out of time. Show me how you want it to be. Tell me, baby, 'cause I need to know now. Oh, because my loneliness is killing me. I must confess, I still believe. When I'm not with you, I lose my mind. Give me a sign.
on, Shuddy.
Let's go.
Oh, I can't do it. Woo, woo. Oh, da, da, da. Harmonies in the background there. Let's change up the style, but where are we? Oh, this is, oh, that could kind of work. This is MGMT, Kingshine, nice. One, two, one, two, three, four.
Talk about 7,100 views, bro.
Like an electric eel.
We'll talk about it.
Baby girl, you turn me on. Turn me on with electric feel. This song has like a real typical chord progression. It goes to heaps of songs. If I could write you a song to make you fall in love, I would already have you up under my arm. I used up all of my tricks. I hope that you like this, but you probably won't. You think you're cooler than me. You got designer shades just to hide your face, and you wear them around like you're cooler than me. And you never say hey or remember my name. It's probably because you think you're cooler than me. Oh. Swim away through the darkness. Yeah.
guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. Tell me I'm too young to understand. You see, I'm caught up in a dream. Life will pass me by if I can open up my eyes, but I can't feel my face when I'm with you.
Stop
but
doing
I love it.
Hey!
But I love it. Oh, I can't feel my face when I'm with you. But I love it. But I love it. You've been putting up with my shit just way too long.
Oh, you're just showing off.
So gifted finding what I don't like the most.
Now you're showing off.
So I think it's time for us to have a toast. Let's have a toast for the douchebag. Let's have a toast for the asshole. Toast for the scumbag. I know.
No.
The jerk off.
Yeah.
Never take work out. Ooh. Baby, I've got a plan. Run away as fast as you can.
You are a piece of shit, and let me tell you what.
Amazing. Woo. Amazing.
Incredible.
Let's have a toast to it.
Payne, what did you say?
I would like to have that hook one more time. Let's have a toast to the douchebag.
You want
to
go again?
Oh, you want that hook?
You said hook one more time.
Yeah, yeah. So start from I always find something wrong.
No. Just let's have a toast to the
douchebag. Hey, Payne, just so you know, you're clicking a little bit on your mic.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Hey.
Let's have a toast for douchebags. Let's have a toast for the assholes. Let's have a toast for the scumbags. Every one of them that I know. Toast for the jerk off. That'll never take one cup. Baby, I got a plan. Run away as fast as you can.
Okay, I'm good. Thank you. That's all I wanted.
Woo!
That's all I wanted. Thank you. Thank you.
Magic. Yeah,
that was great. That
we
was
have awesome. Created magic.
Dude, I can't believe that I sung Kanye, my favorite Kanye West song with T-Pain live in Animal Crossing.
How is this? How is this real life? How is
this
real life?
That's my favorite, dude. That's my favorite.
Amazing, amazing. Dude. Now. We are going to start wrapping up the show, but, and Payne, I apologize if I forgot to tell you about this ahead of time. I think I did tell you, but I may be ambushing you with this. We do have a tradition here on the show where we do like to have everyone, all of our guests, come over here and step up to the microphone here and tell a joke. And it doesn't have to be funny. In fact, they're usually not on this show.
Okay.
But who would you like to go first, or would you like to think of a joke while someone else go first? Totally up to you. You got one for us?
I got an anecdote, or I don't know if I got a joke.
Whatever is gonna work for you.
Okay, I'm gonna move my camera to make it seem like I'm more important. Okay, cool.
Okay. hold on.
So. Okay, are we ready?
Let me, Payne, step around the other side of the mic. You want to be facing the light in front of you. There you go. You got it.
Wait, there?
You're right there. You got it.
Okay, there it is. This guy says, wait, fuck.
I'm going to regret this. I just know
it. You're going to regret it so bad. Okay, so... This guy goes to the doctor, right? And he's like, Doc, what the fuck? And Doc's like, what's happening, bro? And he's like, look, man, my breath is crazy bad. I don't know what's going on. I don't know what's happening, but it's obviously something you did. And he's like, okay, tell me everything that's going on in your life. And he's like, look, I get on the bus. My breath is bad. I'm talking to people. They tell me my breath is bad. I'm going on into Congress. I'm important, Doc. And these people are telling me my breath is bad. Now I'm getting nervous in all these places, and I can't do anything to fix my breath. I think I have halitosis. And the doc is like, well, you know, halitosis is like when your breath is just bad regardless. And he's like, yeah, I know that. That's why I said that. And the doc looks him over, checks all the shit, blah, blah, blah. And the doc is like, my dude, I figured it out. I know what has to happen. And the guy is like, Doc, if you don't fucking fix my breath today, we're going to have to fucking sever ties and we got to leave. And the doc says, guy, I got it. Guess what the doc says?
What?
He says, you either got to stop scratching your ass or stop biting your fingernails.
All right, we got it. We got it. You're in the books. You're in the books. Who's up next? Who's up next?
I'll give you a short one. How about that?
Payne is cracking himself up. Okay, Billy, you gotta get over here to the mic. You gotta get yourself over here.
Come nice on. And short.
Oh, wait, I need a waiting on that.
Payne is cracking himself up right now.
Is the chat gonna do it? I'm waiting on chat.
At the end, Payne, we put this to a vote. Everyone votes and we decide who has the funniest joke. So we gotta get everyone's joke in first, though. Payne, if you'd like to step away from the mic so Billy can step up, that would be wonderful.
Thank you. I don't feel comfortable.
He doesn't
with that.
Want to give up the mic.
No, here we go.
All right, we're good. All right, let's do it, Billy.
Nice. Well, you guys know I'm a scientist, right? So before I started doing this whole music thing, I spent a lot of time in labs doing statistical things, doing chemical things, doing that kind of stuff. And I'm a big fan of science, and I like what science brings to the table. Yeah. And as a scientist, I've noticed that the average person is actually very mean.
Fuck. Oh my God. I missed it. It took me a second. It went right by me.
I cracked myself
up. It's a thinker. It's a thinker,
can I,
Billy.
Can I come back? Can I come back?
Yeah. Wait, yeah. What, you want to do another one?
No, I just want to, mine is more, this one is more of an observational.
Oh my God. What is happening?
Because I was playing Warzone with my Canadian friends, and we were talking about Elon Musk.
Uh-huh.
And I just want to make an observation real quick. Am I allowed to do that?
Can I stop you?
No.
Go for it.
Elon Musk is the DJ Khaled of science.
Elon Musk is the DJ Khaled of science.
You're not wrong, man. Like that, I know what you're saying.
Thank
I know
you.
What you're saying.
I've got it. I'd very much like to thank you.
Okay,
that's a reasonable
Chastity
observation.
Chastity Vicenzio, please step up to the microphone.
She stepped up.
Hey.
All right, go for it.
Gary. So yeah. You and I are both toast enthusiasts. So this one's for you.
All right, I'm ready.
Okay. Do you know why bread is like the sun?
No.
It rises in the east and sets in the west.
Oh,
wow.
Wow.
All right. Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Holy
All right.
shit.
I'll give you that one.
Yeah.
Damn it.
Are we done? Are we done? I don't think I want to tell a joke. Adam, do you want to tell a joke?
I would very much like you to tell a joke, Gary. Come on.
Gary, go
now.
I don't know if I have one for you right now.
You okay. have one right now.
Right.
Go, let's
okay.
go.
Okay. All right. I'll tell you, this is a bad one. Okay. So a guy calls his vet in the middle of the night and says, I've got big problems here. My dog is out in the backyard furiously having sex with another dog, and I can't get them to separate. I can't get them to stop having sex. I've thrown a bucket of water on them. I've shouted at them. I've done everything I can to stop them. I can't stop them going at it. What can I do? And the vet says, here's what you do. Go take your phone, take it out to the backyard, and then ring the phone. And like call the phone with the phone right next to the dog. He says, will that work? He says, well, it just worked on me.
Wow.
I'm here. I'm here to
save the show. That's all I needed.
That's all I needed. Adam, you got one?
Yeah, Adam's gonna tell us.
I got one. All right.
I can't wait.
On?
Is it milk related, like all your other jokes?
They're not all milk related. They're dairy
T-Pain,
related.
I know this is your first time on the show. You may not be aware. Adam only tells dairy related jokes. It's very strange.
All right. They're not all dairy, but let me
dairy related.
Tell the joke. Let's go. Let's hear it.
What is the worst part of milking a cow?
I don't know.
The smell of the dairy air.
Okay, the poll is up. You'll see it at the top of the chat. Please go ahead and vote. T-Pain T-Pain is ahead in the early voting.
I can't get it right.
Adam is way in the back where he belongs. Way off in the distance. Is T-Pain up at the mic again? What is he doing?
I am at the mic again.
Do you have another one?
Just don't appreciate humor.
I'm just trying to get ahead of the game, man, you know?
T-Pain, you'll be glad to hear that you are running away with it here in the voting.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know. It looks like Chastity's like going to win.
You know what? I take it back. Chastity is now in the lead.
Hey.
You know what? I'm so glad that Chastity is going to take something out of this show. Because... The poor girl, she came on and struggled to get a word in edgeways. And I did my best, Chastity, but you see what I'm dealing with here, right? You do get it. You understand what's going on.
It's a lot.
Chastity, congratulations.
Thank you.
35% of the vote. She ran it. She won it in a landslide.
Thanks, Chat. I was very nervous about that. Thank you.
Were you nervous about it?
Yeah, because it's so corny.
That's what we like here. Hey, T-Pain, do you want me to tell the first joke that was ever told on this show? And we've actually had it a number of times now, because it turns out we've busted people on the show this way. When you Google the word joke, this is literally the first joke that comes up. And this is like the baseline that we have here. I think I may have told you this during the for some reason, it really tickles me. I like this joke. Chastity, you probably have not heard this. So I'll tell it to you. You can be my partner on this joke. What's the best thing about living in Switzerland?
What is it?
I don't know, but the flag is a big plus.
Oh, man.
All right. Okay. Look, it's time. It is time.
Is it time?
It's. You know. I got it. I haven't had my dinner yet, Payne. I feel like you could just stick around all night. You just want to keep going, which I love, which I love dearly. Prior to the show, you were all provided with party poppers, and I would like to invite you now to bring out your party poppers.
You know. But.
What? What is it? What is
you
it?
You gave me a present yesterday.
Oh, I would also like to invite you now to unwrap your... you've already got a million bell crown, so you're well ahead. But I would also invite you...
I got the crown, but it's
Billy,
like...
Billy, maybe I didn't brief you on this, but get the hell out of my chair.
Let me live a dream.
If you stay in that chair 1 second longer, you'll be living a nightmare, my friend.
Chastity, you gotta let Payne out of his chair.
Okay.
All right. Payne, for everyone, Chastity, did I give you a gift? Did I give you a gift prior to the show? I would like to invite you now to please unwrap the gift.
It's a raccoon figurine.
It's the worst object in the game.
I would love to see this.
You see, it's actually...
It's the one back there.
It's back there by the golf clubs. You see the raccoon back there by the golf clubs?
No.
In the back.
Oh, this guy.
You can now take that back to your island.
Best item in the game.
Thank you so much, guys.
Best item in the game.
So good.
It's really wonderful.
It's so great.
How we top this, I don't know, but what an amazing show.
Oh, I'll tell you how you top this next week. What the fuck? Oh, tomorrow? What the fuck?
We've got some amazing guests coming up, but none of them are T-Pain. T-Pain, you have set the bar so high, I honestly don't know what we're going to do.
Garrett,
if AOC is watching this, she's got to be thinking, how do I top this?
Gary,
Yeah.
Shut up.
We are back here tomorrow night. God knows why. We are back here tomorrow night. Danny Trejo will be here. Elijah Wood will be here live. And who's Greg Grunberg will be here live. It's an all-star from top to bottom show. It's going to be absolutely incredible.
Gary.
Yes, yes. I'm trying to do my job here. I'm trying to do the outro.
Next week. What's next week?
Pain.
It's a secret.
I know I'm going to regret
saying this. You said it early in the stream. You said it.
I said what? What did I say?
You said what you told me not to say earlier.
What did I say?
Who's coming on?
I don't know what he's talking about.
Who the fuck's coming on the show next week?
Oh, next week, AOC. We think, but we don't know for sure. We're working it out.
Who's popping? Okay.
T-Pain, do you should have a party popper on your person.
I do, and I feel like. Okay.
Okay. Again, Wild Pain works that out. Again, yes, tomorrow night.
I got it.
Same time, 7 p.m. Pacific, 10 p.m. Eastern, right here, twitch.tv/GaryWitter. Danny Trejo will be here live. Elijah Wood will be here live.
Are there machetes on this game?
Greg Grunberg will be here live. And also, we have a special celebrity guest, a mystery guest will be on the show that we haven't announced.
Oh, there's a mystery now?
It's going to be a mystery guest. thank you so much to all of you. I am going to include T-Pain in it.
Greg? Gary.
Yes. There you go.
What's up, man?
What's up, Payne?
I feel like you're downplaying the shit that you're about to do.
What am I about to do?
Next week. I feel like you're like downplaying it.
Are you talking about the AOC thing?
Yeah, the fucking AOC.
It's not confirmed. I'm talking to her people, but I don't want to make promises that I don't want to put her in a position.
Like, well, guess what?
When she's confirmed, I will. Don't believe me. I'm going to promote it, but like I need to.
Oh no! No! This is the promotion right here. She's doing it. She's fucking doing it.
I mean, if she's watching this show right now, I don't know if this is making her want to do it more or less. I don't know.
Yeah, this is making her want to do it. Well, she can't deny it now. Now she has to do it.
Now she has to do it. I mean, how do you
top this?
We'll see you back here tomorrow night. Thank you so much, everyone. To my guests, of course, the incredible, I have no words, T-Pain.
I'm just going to ruin
Chastity
this whole
Vincenzio.
Shit.
Very handsome, very handsome Billy. My band leader, and sidekick, and he's my everything, Adam Nickerson. My wife and executive producer, Leah Witter, Kate Stark, all my moderators, everyone who helps on the show.
Thank you
so much. Party poppers on 1, 2, 3, go.
Yeah!
Thank you. Stick around. We are going to go raid. Billy's going to go fire up his stream now.
I only had one.
What? What?
Do you need multiple party streamers to like pop?
I've got another one here. I got another one. I'll blow another one. Here you go. Right here. Boom. There you go.
Roll the credits.
Oh, was that four?
I'm going to roll the credits. Okay. Billy, go fire up your stream. I'm going to dump everyone into your stream. We're going to have after party at Very Handsome Billy's channel. But for right now, thank you so much. And we'll see you all back here tomorrow night.
Now you fucked up.
Oh my god.
Yeah, this is my shit.